And of course, that creative element to it, and also.
To you, you beautiful people. Welcome to your Feel Good Breakfast Show Expresso here on SABC3. Get in there, ladies!
Yes,
give me that energy. Listen, I'm very excited because today is all about the gamers out there. If you know anything about me, is that me and FIFA, we're like this. So this is going to be the best. We were revealing Samsung's brand new 49-inch curved gaming monitor that is about to revolutionize the gaming world out there.
Oh, cannot wait. We're also looking at some local entertainment news. And you know that Samizi was in the US recently.
Yes.
He tells us all about the American dream, and trust me, it's not what you think.
Oh, wow. Okay, well listen, speaking about America, we're gonna look also in our What's Trending report at America's next top meowdle, and I'm being specific there because we're looking at cats.
Oh, okay.
These cats, looking all model schmoddly.
Are they really walking down the catwalk this time around?
I don't know, but I see
what you
did there.
Yeah. Another walk.
But we also like to keep it nice and local, and making music for us today, the KhoisanBoy.Man. There he is, acoustic guitar player, singer, songwriter, and loop artist as well. Can't wait to hear his music on this Feel Good Wednesday. Thank you so much for joining us. Let's get the day underway and take a look at all of the temperatures around our cities.
It's going to be an incredible Wednesday indeed. Good morning, South Africa, from our side as well. Let's have a feel-good one together. Now, in your weather this morning, it is partly cloudy in most parts of the country today with a chance of showers in some parts of the Eastern Cape. Your temperature, Polokwane, skop af op 10 grade minimum and a maximum 28. Mombela, 13.33. Pretoria, 13.28. Johannesburg, 12 and a maximum 27. Mahikeng, begin op 12 and a maximum 30. Lekker warm. Klerksdorp, 12.29. Kimberley, 9.29. Ook een maximum van 29 later vandaag. Bloemfontein skop af op 7, dat stijgt naar 27. Richards Bay 16.25. Pietermaritzburg on 13 with a maximum 26. Durban 18.24. Mthatha 10.22. And then looking at East London starting off on 15 with a maximum 20. Craddock 11 with a maximum 30. Port Elizabeth 13.20. George 10.20. Sutherland starting off on a cool 3 degrees minimum and staying cool with a maximum 16. Cape Town 12.16. Worcester 6.18. Springbok 1 minimum this morning with a maximum 18. And Upington starting off on 9 with a maximum 28 degrees. Well, that's a wrap of your weather and temperatures at 6.30. We'll keep you updated with those temperatures throughout the course of your Wednesday. I'm back just after 7 o'clock with another look.
Well, let's get your Wednesday morning started by taking a look at your traffic. And this morning we start off in KZN, as you can expect major delays. That's due to an accident on the N3 Joburg bound near Frankfurt and the Freda interchange. Now the entire road is closed and traffic is already heavily backed up. Please use an alternative route where possible. And in the Western Cape and Cape Town, expect some congestion. That's on the N2 inbound with traffic backing up towards the Bunga Avenue exit. Well, that's where we leave your traffic for now. I'll have another update for you in 30 minutes. It's time to take our very first look at what's happening in the world of social media, and we're checking out our Facebook page this morning. We asked you that we're looking for Wednesday wisdom. Where do you find meaning in your life? Kicking us off this morning, Amber says, good morning. I found meaning in my life when I gave birth to my son on Friday. He will be 2 years old. He keeps me on my toes. Don't they do that? Thule says, I find meaning in my life in waking up every day and making it count. Yes. Tapelo says, I found it in myself. You are the one in charge of your
own life. Snacks Madolo says, I found it in God and my Bible and my daughter. And then Ellie says, good morning, studio. Good morning, Ellie. And Lindo says, I find meaning of life through the book of life, which is the Bible, and through prayer. Hallelujah. What an awesome way to start the morning. Let us know where you find meaning in your life on this Wisdom Wednesday.
Yeah. Yeah. We're trying to think up what the South African dream would be, because Samizi was recently in America and he found out a bit more about the American dream, and apparently,
you know,
he's not.
I think it's safe to say that he is actually living the South African dream.
Yeah,
if there's such a thing. Absolutely. Anyways, listen, here's something I think is a story that Zoe will most definitely enjoy.
Yeah.
America's next top meowdle.
Meowdle.
Meowdle. Yeah, I have no clue what that is all about. We'll find out after the break.
Common reactor. No, it doesn't work.
Finding products that are versatile and easy to use in many aspects of your life isn't that easy. Or is it? I've discovered the full range of Glad Zip Seal bags, and I've gone crazy using them all over the house. In the kitchen, in the bedroom, in the bathroom, the list goes on. Let's focus on the kitchen for now. The Glad Zip Seal seals tight and locks in freshness. The Glad Zip Seal is so clever. One side's yellow, the other side's blue. Seal it together and it turns green. You can use these bags to store ingredients, snacks, or even your lunch. They're great for picnics. Another one of my favorite features is the write-on strip. You can write your name, the ingredients, the date, or just a special message. Yum!
Imagine, if you will, a space where you and I could thrive forevermore. Imagine, if you will, a space where you and I could thrive forevermore. No more chasing, no more wasting precious time.
Oh,
Welcome back. This is your Feel Good Breakfast show. Listen, I love this tune because we get to find out what our local stars have been up to, and you've got some exciting news.
Yes, well, we all heard Angelina Gerber and Jacques Potgieter are expecting another little one, right? But sometimes you just have to wait for Instagram to make it super, super official. And this time, Angelique actually confirmed the pregnancy with an adorable photo of herself and hubby holding a positive pregnancy test. But it gets better, you guys. She's not pregnant with one baby. She's pregnant with twins.
Daar's twee van
hulle. Hello. And of course, we are very, very excited about that. So some feel-good news for you on your Feel Good Breakfast show. Hey?
How's that for a skipskop deur die pale?
Listen.
Twee van hulle. Daar's hy, lekker.
It's going to be awesome.
Well, done. Well done.
Remember how Samizi was in the USA last week to cover the MTV VMAs and gave us all major FOMO? Well, it seems that he didn't really, or rather we didn't really miss out on much, as Samizi says the US dream is overrated.
Really?
Now, on his radio show this week, Sumgaga said that he felt underwhelmed by the trip and that instead of aspiring to kill it in the US, we should all focus on killing it here in South Africa and in Africa. And we know that both Mzansi and Africa has so much undiscovered and undepreciated talent. So, Samizi, we're definitely with you on this one.
Wow.
I want to say, yes, you have to kill it here.
Yes.
But there, I think things are just on a whole other level.
It's so much bigger. And could it possibly also be like you're so used to being recognized and you're so used to everybody knowing, and when you get there, you're just
ordinary.
My thoughts on that is that like we have an entire African continent that we
100%.
Can, you know, dominate in. And, you know, when you have the United States of Africa and the United States of America, you know, making it here could be just as big for you as an artist, as a presenter, as a CEO on the African continent.
Yeah. Like, but I think you've got to go there to realize exactly what a gem we have here, and we should appreciate it a lot more.
Or just trust us and take Somizi's word for it.
True story.
Okay. Anyway. Thank you very much for that, Leanne. Well, right about now, if you are a gamer, then hold on to your joystick and prepare yourself for what you're about to witness.
Now, I know that I am quite easily enthused, but when I saw this, my mouth literally fell open. Unbelievable. Samsung have just released their range of curved gaming monitors, which are epic to say the least. And what you are seeing in front of me is the 49-inch QLED curved gaming monitor, a gamer's dream. And it doesn't get much bigger or better than this. And may I add, this is literally the biggest gaming monitor to date on the market. And here to give it a test drive is none other than our gaming pro, Mr. Gareth Woods, having far too much fun, man. You're having to use your whole neck ring.
That's fine. Well, you say test drive. I feel like I need to have a license to be able to operate this thing.
Brother, this is insane. Just straight off the bat, what excites you about this? Give me some specs.
Well, I mean, it's pretty obvious. It's huge. I mean, 49 inches. It's what they call dual HD, which means it actually has two HD screens in one. So you talk about 16:9 ratios. This is 32:9. You can literally split this in half and have two HD displays going on. It's a gaming monitor, and I think one of the key things that gamers look for is response time. So it's 144 hertz monitor, and it might sound quite fancy for those who don't know, but it's how quickly the screen refreshes. And so obviously with games that are very high reflex and very quick, the faster screen refreshes, the kind of edge you'd have as a gamer.
What about this excites gamers specifically? Because I'm a complete newbie here and I'm getting excited. From your perspective, this must be a game changer.
Yeah, so it's awesome for gamers. I think the immersive nature of the curved screen, the fact that you really feel like you're in it, you think particularly of your kind of single player RPG games like this, or your horror games, your first person shooters would be great. But also the utility. So, I mean, if you're a graphic designer or a video editor, the fact that you've got so much more screen space, you know, it's just so much more convenient than having to print stuff out or have multiple screens up.
It's the ultimate multitasker. Can we send a shout out to Rebel Tech, who put together this awesome piece of the water cooling? It just looks incredible. It looks quite fitting next to this monitor.
Yeah, you have a monster PC as well, yeah.
Graphically, obviously, and we're playing Witcher 3 here, which, I mean, it's beautiful graphics today. I'm just watching his hair blow in the wind, and the difference in the clouds, the depth of field. So we've got whiter whites, we've got blacker blacks, if that's even possible. The graphics from a gaming perspective, that's also going to be a major plus.
Yeah, so, I mean, it's one of those things where, obviously, you'll still need a beast of a PC to power, you know, the game looking like this. I mean, everything's set to ultra graphics and like dialed up to 11. But what's awesome is that if you have a monitor like this, you can really take advantage of it. Yeah, you really see how the game was meant to be played.
You touched very lightly on the multitasking aspects, and as much as this is gaming, and I mean, there is a fair bit of multitasking within a gaming framework as well, but just in general, this must be the ultimate multitasking tool.
Yeah, so I mean, like I was saying, if you've got spreadsheets open, if you've got, you know, you can have a game open at the same time, you could be tracking your stats or whatever, you know, some of your esports titles that'll have stats tracking and all that sort of stuff. You can do that at the same time.
How hungry are you for the screen now in your home?
Oh yeah, that's the worst part now. Now I have to go home and look at my 24-inch monitor and think about this one.
Compatibility with consoles, PCs?
Yeah, so pretty much compatible with everything. The only issue sometimes will be certain games won't run natively at these resolutions, but then what will happen, it'll just crop it to the size. But I mean, a lot of games and more games are coming out at bigger and bigger resolutions.
Well, this really is a game changer, as I've said about 50 times, dude. I won't distract you anymore.
As I ride into the sunset.
Yeah, quite literally, man. And look at that beautiful sunset. That is quantum dot technology right there. Ah, so guys, stick around because this monitor isn't going anywhere. We've got a couple of gamers coming in here. We're going to really put this monitor to the test, and we are going to be giving this beast a real push. See how far we can take this technology. And we've got another beautiful little surprise thrown in just for you, so you better stick around. Oh, wow, man.
At Samsung, we develop technology so you can live life. Samsung, a way of life.
Oh, super cool stuff. I can totally see myself playing games all day. Okay, maybe not all day.
Heaven, that screen.
Yeah.
But it's been a while since I actually played computer games.
Yeah, you know?
It's
right?
All about consoles nowadays and whatnot, but computer gaming, man, it's still old school.
Yeah. Well, right now it's time for us to check out all of those interesting and funny and random things that we've stumbled across on social media this morning and hopefully put a smile on your face.
Yeah, well, how's this one? We know when it comes to back to school, you know, kids aren't always thrilled to go back to school. It's a bit of a trana doll, you didn't dart. But parents don't always seem to share that same sentiment with the kids. Yeah, so there's a couple of pictures floating around out there of parents just sharing how they feel about their kids going back to school.
Happy first day of school, kids. I'm going to miss y'all.
Oh, that is funny.
First day of school, the orange juice.
Check out the
parents
camping chairs.
Like, oh, look at the dad like squishing the kids back in the car. Like,
get in there.
Okay, next one. How creepy would it be for you to meet your doppelganger? Somebody who really actually looked like you.
That would be weird.
Yeah, some people say it's the best thing ever. Some people say it's an omen of bad luck. But Board Panda put together pictures of people who met their doppelgangers and looked to like where looking liking moved.
No way.
Oh, what? That's crazy.
Oh my.
No way. Yeah. Are you serious?
My friend met his dog. That is crazy.
That is scary.
You know what's even scarier? The fact that they have the same kind of beard cut.
Glasses.
Because, kind of, I mean, living across the world.
I have a friend that looks like that as well. We could make it a quadruple.
A what?
A triple.
A triple ganger.
A triple ganger.
That doesn't sound good. No. Erase.
Listen, something that will sound cool is, listen, we've been talking about this the whole morning. There's one little cat that's strutting her stuff on the runway, and we have to say, I think we found America's next top.
Oh, yeah.
How cute is that? Can we see that again? That was way too quick. Please walk for us. You have to stretch your stuff. It's a beautiful kitty cat.
No, too sexy for my shirt. Too sexy for my...
Nah, it's a terrible theme song for... Anyway, let us know what you've been following on social media. Share it with us and use hashtag Expresso Show. That was cute. That's quite nice.
So we can't have the world's largest gaming monitor in our studio without really putting it to the test. So we brought in some pro gamers to really test this beast out this morning. And we've got a nice little surprise for you as well. So stick around.
And we also can't have an incredible artist in studio without putting him to the test. We've got the KhoisanBoy.Man in studio. And trust me, you are going to be entertained. All that and more coming up on your Feel Good Breakfast Show.
Just take the loop quickly.
Can we check?
Sure. Cool.
Just do like a bit of looping.
Mm.
guys, a quick mic check for me, please.
Check, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2.
It's my feel-good breakfast show.
Welcome back. You're live with Expresso on a beautiful hump day. It's a Wednesday morning and we are having too much fun in studio this morning. Samsung have exclusively sent us their incredible 49-inch curved gaming monitor, the biggest in the market. We are absolutely thrilled to have the beast here with us and we're keeping it all morning. And to do it justice, we've invited six very passionate gamers into studio. They'll be playing all morning, putting their own skills to the test on this beast. And as you can see, they've already got going behind me, just coming to terms with it. We've got a bit of a racer going on there. We've got Witcher 3 going on, an unbelievable game. So we've got two separate console games plugged in at the same time. That's how big this monitor is. And they're playing side by side, epic to say the least. So to make things interesting, we are going to have a little friendly knockout tournament. And because of this, Samsung have given us a 27-inch curved gaming monitor that will be rewarded to our winner today. Morning, guys. Does that sound good? So I hope I didn't make it real there. Suddenly things got real, and today's game is all about speed and achieving the best lap time possible. So we're giving them a little bit of time to get into it, but here are the rules in round one. We'll see two players racing against the clock, and the winner of each round will then progress to round two. But the person with the fastest lap time in round one will progress straight to the final. It's your golden ticket. Then in round two, we'll see the two winners from round one compete for their spot in that final. And in round three, we'll see who will be crowned the winner and walk away with that unbelievable 27-inch gaming monitor courtesy of Samsung. So we can all say thank you to Samsung quickly. Awesome. And thank you to our gamers. So gamers, you can start warming up those minds, get those synapses firing on all cylinders. This is going to be epic. Stick around.
All right, while all that fun carries on, let's quickly take a brief pause to recognize the fact that in September, we as South Africans celebrate heritage or our heritage during Heritage Month. Now, standing next to me is a man who calls himself KhoisanBoy.Man. His name is actually Gershan Lombard, and he is, as I said, an acoustic singer, songwriter, and loop artist who has taken the South African music scene by storm with his catchy lyrics and catchy music, and of course, his entrancing voice. And he's also had his first offering, an EP called The Infinity Dialogue, that he'll be sharing with us this morning. In fact, he's about to perform one of those tracks right now called Imagine If You Will.
Imagine, if you will, a space where you and I could thrive forevermore. No more chasing, no more wasting precious time. Imagine, if you will, we take our shoes off just for a thrill and we listen to what we have been missing all along. Imagine, if you will, that it's all perfect and there is no expectation and no condemnation for you. Imagine, if you will, infinity stretching and no longer matching. You're here and now. Imagine, if you will, just for a thrill that we are free. Don't you see, we are free to be. Won't you please see me for the first time? Always please see me.
On your feel-good breakfast show. Very, very nice, man. Did I hear you correctly in the words saying, if love is the weapon, then we'll all be fine?
Yes, that's so, yeah.
Wow, man.
Yeah, I just, love it. If love is the weapon, we'll all be fine. That's
beautiful stuff,
really.
Man. Can't wait to hear more music from you, from KhoisanBoy.Man. Let us know what you thought about that performance on this Wednesday morning. And also remember, your offering is out and it's available. People can get it out there.
Available online, SoundCloud, Reverb Nation, Bandcamp, all of the relevant places.
Get in there, man. Get that soothing voice on a Wednesday morning all up in your ears. Right now, let's head on over back to Graham. Much excitement, of course, over there.
We're going to call this trackside for this morning. Forza 6 is about to kick off. We have got Rael, our first competitor, being all neighborly, giving Wenda completely the wrong controls, I'm guessing, yeah? No, that was a lovely spirit that I saw there, guys. All the best of luck. Select your cars, and we're going to kick off your first lap in just a moment. Make it a beast. Hey, if you're going to go with a car, go with a Bugatti. I mean, come on. Please race the Fiat. Come on, dude. Just be like that. No, you don't. Please don't do that. A BM. I went for a Matchbox BM, showing his street cred. Are you guys there? Get your track. And let's rock and roll. So, of course, the winner of our overall competition, we're going to go through three rounds here, is going to walk away with a 24-inch curved screen of their own, which is unbelievable. And, of course, we've got a little competition for you guys at home. Have you got your track? You ready to rock and roll? Warm up. The synapses are firing. We're at Sonoma Raceway. I like that. We're in the US of A for our first showdown between Rael and Wenda. Guys, all the best of luck. Pull no punches. Okay, you're representing all young ladies this morning. You're representing all young men.
Oh,
it is. It's a lot. I'm feeling a little bit nervous. No, it's a really nice prize, guys. Come on. Okay, just think about that while you're racing. Now get into the zone. Get your game faces on. We're getting a nice little display of this track on a beautiful screen here. The screen is a beast. And you're off. Go, ladies and gentlemen. Come on. Getting to terms with her controls. I've got to think that the Bugatti's got to take it on a straight line. So while Rael and Wenda charge off, and of course we're looking for that fastest lap time, we'll go straight into the final three rounds, and it's all going down. But of course you guys at home have an opportunity to win and win big as well. We are going to be giving away a 24-inch curved gaming monitor for you guys at home. So all the best of luck as well. All you have to do is head to our Expresso Facebook page. Tell us what your favorite feature of this incredible piece of new technology is. It's the immersive curved display. Maybe it's the super fast 1 millisecond response time, which you need in a gaming scenario. Maybe it's the adjustable head mount. We don't know. You've got to tell us and tell us on our Expresso Morning Show Facebook page. Share your answer and it could be yours. And we are going big today. Remember, all of those terms and conditions can be found on expressoshow.com. What's going on? Come on, Wenda. Come on, Wenda. You just went super Saiyan there.
He knocked me out of the way.
Did he? He went gangster. It's not him, it's his car. You can't drive a Matchbox BMW. Come on, Wenda. Come on, girl.
Anymore.
That's the problem with a Bugatti. It just, you're just going off script.
Wow.
Oh, you're ruining the nicest car in the game. You're just, now you're just being aggressive.
I'm trying to find shortcuts. I don't know where
now you're going. Just being aggressive and you're breaking your car.
This is me getting
Real is just like drifting in, man. He's just like freewheeling. He's got the clutch in. Come on, Wenda.
I've lost.
Can you reverse? You might have broken your gearbox, is what I'm saying. You might have broken your gearbox.
Oh,
we've got a lap time of 1:43.
Girl, you're gonna be laughing at me.
Oh, yeah. Now, y'all get a turn. Y'all get a turn.
Guys, I'm out.
Oh, beautiful stuff. Okay, so as we wrap up this lap time, which is cruising home, remember, you want to get into that final. Yep. 1:59, 2 minutes, the lap time sits at the moment. We'll return to our game in just a second. Wenda, it's all right, girl. It's all right, girl.
I gave up, guys. I'm sorry.
All the females. It makes me feel even better.
In your national news this morning, motorists are expected to pay more for fossil fuels as of today, with the price of petrol and diesel increasing by 67 cents and 44 cents respectively. The increase comes as a result of a weakening rand against the dollar during the period of review and the higher prices of petroleum in the market. The increase will affect public transport commuters as buses and taxis warn that a fare hike is on the cards. Stats SA has announced that South Africa has broken out of the technical recession with GDP growth of 2.5% in the second quarter of this year. The announcement comes as Statistician General Pali Lehohla gave the second quarter gross domestic product figures at a briefing in Pretoria yesterday. Lehohla says the economy grew quarter on quarter as well as year on year with a 2.5% and 1.1% increase respectively. Now moving further abroad, Hurricane Irma has strengthened into an extremely dangerous Category 5 storm, prompting states of emergency in Puerto Rico, the U.S. Virgin Islands, and Florida. Several islands in the Caribbean are bracing for potentially life-threatening winds, storm surge, and rain within the next 24 hours. Irma's longer-term path remains uncertain, but the latest forecast models are increasingly putting the storm on track to hit southern Florida soon. And then finally, Vladimir Putin has said that new sanctions against North Korea would be useless and ineffective. The Russian president said imposing tougher sanctions on the regime of Kim Jong-un over its nuclear missile program would not change the leadership in Pyongyang, but could lead to large-scale human suffering. Speaking after a BRICS summit in China, Mr. Putin, while condemning North Korea's actions as provocative, also warned against further ramping up of military hysteria, saying it could lead to global catastrophe. Well, that was your 7 o'clock news update. Let's get a very first look at what's happening in the world of sport. Here's Graham.
Football first, and Bafana Bafana's quest for the 2018 World Cup qualification received another blow last night as they fell to Cape Verde in Durban. The 2-1 defeat leaves South Africa bottom of Group D on 4 points with two rounds of fixtures remaining. In those other African qualifying results from last night, Egypt beat Uganda 1-0, Ghana earned a 5-1 win over the Congo, while Burkina Faso and Senegal, they played out to a 2-2 draw. And staying with football, Spain were in goal-scoring form last night, to say the least, as they put 8 unanswered goals past Liechtenstein. That was in the European 2018 World Cup qualifying campaign. Alvaro Morata, Logo Aspas, they both hit the back of the net twice as the 2010 World Cup winners kept their 3-point lead at the top of Group G. Elsewhere, Wales earned a 2-0 win over Moldova, Austria and Georgia. They drew 1-1, while Italy. They beat Israel by 1-0. Then Team Sky's Chris Froome extended his overall lead in the Vuelta a España yesterday as he cruised to victory in the stage 16 time trial. Froome clocking in 47 minutes from the 40.2 kilometer stage, finishing 29 seconds ahead of his nearest competitor, Wilco Kelderman. So on the overall standings, yesterday's win saw Froome move 1 minute and 58 seconds clear of second place Vincenzo Nibali, with five stages still remaining. Then Pablo Carreño Busta booked his place in the last four of the US Open last night as he beat Diego Schwartzman in the quarterfinals. The straight sets win saw the 26-year-old Spaniard progress to a Grand Slam semi-final for the first time in his career after his 16 previous attempts. In the other quarterfinal results from last night, Sloane Stephens downed Anastasia Sevastova, whilst Venus Williams, she beat Petra Kvitova. And that's where we leave our sport for now.
Well, let's take another look at your roads. We start off in Gauteng on the N1 northbound, just after the N17. There's a stationary vehicle on the N1 northbound after the N17. The entry lane is obstructed, so please approach with caution. If you're in KZN, there's also been an accident on the N3 Joburg bound near Frankfurt and the Frieda interchange. Now, emergency lanes have now been open to traffic in both directions. Good luck in the traffic. That's where we leave it for now. I'll bring you another update shortly.
The department need to know, Siva. Let's quickly get into your weather for your Wednesday morning. And it looks like most parts of the country can expect partly cloudy conditions. Then there's also a couple of showers expected in parts of the Eastern Cape today. Your temperature, Polokwane, skop af op 10 grade minimum and a maximum 28. Mbombela 13 and baie warm later vandag 33 grade. Pretoria 13, 28. Johannesburg 12, 27. Mahikeng 12, 30. Klerksdorp 12 and a maximum 29. Kimberley 9, 29. Bloemfontein 7, 27. Richards Bay begin op 16, dit styg na 25. Pietermaritzburg 13, 26. Durban 18 this morning with a mild 24 late on today. Mthatha 10, 22. East London 15, 20. Craddock 11, 30. Port Elizabeth 13, 20. George 10, 20. Sutherland starting up on 3 with a maximum 16. Cape Town 12, 16. Worcester 6, 18. Springbok 1 this morning, nice and cold, reaching a maximum of 18. Degrees, and Upington 9 with a nice and warm maximum of 28 degrees. That's a wrap of your weather and temperatures for your 7 o'clock bulletin. We've got one final update heading your way just after 8.
Turkish Airlines, widen your world.
So let's see whether we can awaken that grey matter on this Wednesday morning and see if you're on top of your game when it comes to entertainment news out there or the gaming world with our emoji charades game, where we show you a couple of emojis, we give you some clues and see whether you can piece it all together. And of course, yours is to link up with us on social media and then let us know what you have guessed. All right.
That's
so
right.
Oh, what are we looking at today?
Okay, well, as you can see, we have a music note. There's two, which means it has two words in it. We have a snail and we have a set of hats.
You got it.
Okay, well, listen, the clues are as follows. This funk pop song was released earlier this year. It was co-written by Irish singer and songwriter, and the artist said the lyrics changes the stereotypical roles of what would usually happen when two people meet in a bar.
Okay, so think about that and look at those emojis. And then, of course, if you know what movie, what series or song this is, let us know on our Facebook page or on Twitter using the hashtag Expresso Show, and try out our emoji charades game.
So we're going to take a quick break. When we return, our gamers continue in their quest for that 27-inch curved monitor. It's absolutely amazing. Of course, we had Rail, our first winner. Well done, buddy. Nice job, nice job. And we're also going to do a little bit of horsing around in Kyalami, then give you some vital information you need to know about one of the big scams doing the rounds at the moment. We'll see you in a sec.
Turkish Airlines, voted Europe's best airline for 6 consecutive years, widens your world with outstanding hospitality as you journey in style to your destination. Enjoy a stopover in Istanbul and discover the colors of this fascinating city. With Turkish Airlines, your stopover will include complimentary accommodation in Istanbul, and you can experience the wonder of two continents combined in an unforgettable adventure. To learn more about the best stopover in travel, visit turkishairlines.com.
takes a while to
set up a spot. I was going to ask you some questions.
It's my feel-good breakfast show.
Welcome back. Thank you so much for tuning in, and thank you so much for all of our gamers joining us this morning. Your reward, well, at least for one of you, a 27-inch curved Samsung gaming monitor. We've got our latest two competitors, Jonathan and Robin, trying to stay on the track. Come on, boys. Competing for that final position. We are going for the fastest lap time today. We've got three rounds. The winner of that final, as I said, wins themselves that unbelievable curved 27 inch. Oh, that's rough, Brew. That's rough. We've entered into the trenches now. So we've got Robin and Jonathan on track at the moment. And of course, Rael took our first showdown. How are you feeling, buddy?
I'm feeling actually great, eh? I'm feeling actually great. But actually, in a way, I'm feeling disappointed in myself because I actually beat a girl. So I'm supposed to, be a gentleman, you know?
Yeah, I don't know if you gave her the right controls. You were helping her out with...
I think you might have done that on purpose.
Earned it fair and square, buddy. Yeah. You earned it fair and square in your Matchbox PM. So congratulations. You moved through to our next round. Whether you've got the fastest lap time, I don't know, 1.45. That sounds pretty fast, but I know absolutely nothing
about this. Actually, I had a small car and a very slow car, so I kind of just did it.
It sounds like you're making excuses already, man. I'm going to put it out there. So Jonathan and Robin, doing fairly well. If we could reverse. This seems to be the most difficult part of this game. Of course, we're playing Forza 6 at the moment. Beautiful racing game, but there's quite a lot of nuance here. And a pretty tough track at that. But I think we are seeing a pretty fast lap time already. Come on, boys. Just keep on going. We're going to bring you the winner of that in just a moment. And then, of course, we'll bring you another round, and we'll see who is going to make it into that final. And you guys, you can win yourself a 24-inch curved gaming monitor yourself. Go onto our Facebook page. Tell us what you love about this monitor the most, and we'll be giving one of those to one very, very lucky viewer.
Listen to the sound of that game as well. Sounds like there's plenty of horsepower underneath that bonnet. Uh-huh. Hey, and speaking of horses, in South Africa, the history of domesticated horses dates back to 1653 when the Dutch East India Company brought horses to the country for the first time.
That's right. Well, you know what? There are pockets around South Africa where communities are embracing equestrian-centered, and it becomes part of the business and the lifestyle of some of these areas. And in Kyalami, there are about 2,000 horses, so it only became natural that a horse becomes an ambassador for a new local shopping hub.
It is a truly glorious day here in the City of Gold, and nestled within this lovely equestrian community is Kyalami Corner, a retail center that is dedicated to this area's very rich equestrian heritage. And of course, it's only fitting that their ambassador is the majestic horse. Now, the horse of the season has finally arrived. It's the finale today. So I have donned the official attire so I can trot my way into a front row seat to see the semi-finalist horses compete for that coveted seasonal title, and it's all going to be going down in Kyalami Corner's lunge ring.
This is the first ever competition where a horse winning the title of being a retail center's brand ambassador, and these majestic beauties were tough to judge.
Ray, what criteria were you basing the judging on?
Something that's going to make us proud. So overall, you know, presence, breeding, of course, and of course that creative element to it, and also personality, you know. So I think we're looking for that little something extra, you know, so not just the normal stuff, just that I think something that the community also can relate to, and I think once again have that affinity with.
The judges were looking for a brand ambassador that would make the community's heart gallop, and they found it in an 11-year-old ex-racehorse turned show jumper named Valiant.
Thank you very much for everybody. So this horse, I like him so much, and I'm very appreciate that this horse is take number one today. So thank you very much, everyone.
Candace, congratulations. I think we've all fallen in love with Valiant just a little bit, but from your experience with this beautiful animal, what makes him so special and your relationship such a unique one?
This horse came off the racetrack and he was quite a nightmare. In fact, he was quite untrusting of people. He didn't want to be around in anyone's space. We used to dodge back legs, dodge teeth. And we just crept into each other's heart and soul, and he makes me feel safe. He makes me feel like I'm invincible when I'm in the show ring. He's got a competitive nature, and he shows it in every aspect of his life.
Valiant's prize includes 10,000 rands worth of goodies from the elite Kyle Army Corner tenants, and he'll appear on Kyle Army Corner's promotional material.
Each one of our semi-finalists had very different attributes and certainly standout features, both in the look and their kind of energy. What made Valiant your winner today?
I liked the way that Valiant and Candace were turned out. I thought that Candace looked absolutely beautiful. I loved her dress, I loved her hair. Valiant was very clean. It's obviously very difficult to keep a grey horse clean like that. I liked the fact that he was plaited. I just thought that he looked very smart, and especially as a brand ambassador for the centre, I thought that he was very well suited.
All that horsing around has left me starved, so I think it's time to see if I can track down something tasty to eat.
Kyle Army Corner boasts a choice of restaurants that would impress even the biggest gourmet foodie. From grills to pizza, there's something for every taste. Hello Tomato is a restaurant that was inspired in New York, conceived in Italy, and born in Joburg.
We spent 2 weeks in Italy. We trained on making dough and making pizza. We went to the World Pizza Championships, and we brought that to South Africa. So we're making authentic artisanal pizzas with a very quirky South African twist to it.
What's your favorite, dude?
My favorite's this one. So it's chicken tikka masala and some coriander. That's al forno baked pasta, ragu mama, classic Regina, and then what the kids love is normally a nice Hawaiian.
The family-friendly shopping center features a design using natural materials and encouraging lots of natural light. Having opened in April this year, it offers residents of Kyle Army as well as those visiting the precinct an incredible variety, luxury, and an atmosphere that is a celebration of the community's wonderful equestrian heritage.
Yeah, it looks like the horses are really running the economy in that part of the country,
They are indeed.
Yeah, money, money, ingi, mali. Speaking of which, money, if you were to take your money to the laundromat for a wash and an iron, that might not get you arrested.
Nope, but allowing criminals to use your bank account for criminal activity will.
Yeah, and that's why Kilani Pillay, the CEO of Sabric, tells us a bit more about money laundering.
Duffel bags, high-speed car chases, and secret bank vaults. I'm pretty sure when you think of money laundering, this is what you picture. But this particular scam is an everyday reality and not just something that happens in the movies. To tell us a bit more about this very serious and real criminal offence, we are joined by Kalyani Pillay, CEO of Sabric, the South African Banking Risk Information Centre. We've loved walking this journey of empowerment with you, and I'm going to say that because I feel empowered knowing what I now know. This is an area, though, that kind of elicits an emotional response to be connected to movies. We see it as kind of very much connected to the mob and gangsters, but this is something that's happening every day. Some of us might be unwittingly involved in that practice. Define it for us. What is money laundering, essentially?
Well, money laundering is a process that criminals would use to try and clean their money. You know, it's taking dirty money and making it legitimate. And they look for various ways to do that. And they unfortunately use a lot of innocent people along the way.
I think some people might even be complicit knowingly because they are offered, it seems like you're not hurting anyone. It's the victimless crime, but that really is not the reality. But of course, so many people are duped into it unwittingly. Are you then held responsible if your account or if you are in some way used in that money laundering process?
Well, you certainly will be considered to be complicit in a very serious crime. So what happens is that these organized syndicates actually look for people so that they could utilize their bank accounts. And so they try to use people who already have legitimate bank accounts for an offer of some kind of payment. People are asked to rent out their accounts to people. In other words, open an account and let me use it. And they give you some kind of sad story so that you allow them to use their account. And again, there may be an offer for a couple of rands. And they know that. We've had instances of where people who are unemployed standing at a street corner waiting to get a contract work or, you know, a temporary job somewhere. And they would go in and pick up all of these people, take them to a bank, say, look, you've got to open accounts because we're going to give you a job and we need your account. And then they would even take the card away from those people, say, at the end of the month, when we pay you, we'll give you your card back. In the meantime, they now have accounts that
they
can utilize.
They've got 30 people that they
can
use.
So we're saying, you know, you are a money mule if you allow that to happen. You are complicit or be considered to be complicit and could be charged. So we're urging bank customers not to ever allow their bank account to be used by anybody else, but also not to open a bank account in their name for somebody else to use.
Are there some warning signs or ways that we can protect ourselves, without the information being a big part of that, but what advice do you have for people out there? Who's most at risk?
Well, the advice is just don't allow anybody to use your bank account for anything, to get a deposit in. Secondly, don't open an account for anybody, because that's like renting out an account. You're opening an account, you don't. And the minute they call it willful blindness. How the law will actually look at it, because you should have
You're
asked questions. You should have asked. If somebody's coming to you with some kind of, you need to be able to ask some questions. But also, very important, if you are suspicious of any kind of unlawful activity like that, you should bring it to the attention of the bank, and you should bring it to the attention of the South African Police Service.
Okay, and go to the police immediately. And I think the best advice we can give in this case, almost, I'm going to say 100% of the time, if it's too good to be true, it is too good to be true.
Absolutely.
Don't let the promise of just a small amount of money allow you to lose a massive amount and your credibility, and ultimately turn you into a criminal on the back end. It may sound like a movie, but scullums are always on the prowl. Never forget it. For more tips on how to wise up and watch out, please visit the SABRIC website and their Facebook and their Twitter pages. Such a vital resource for all of us.
Wise up, watch out.
Also to come on your Feel Good Breakfast Show, we're taking a look at some daily tech news, and how would you like to catch a ride on a flying taxi?
That would be awesome. That would be epic. Yes, we'll bring you that story. And how's this for a story we're going to be talking about? A 17-year-old gamer lands a gaming contract of $150,000. That's around 2 million rand. The interesting thing is he had to get his mom to sign. Wow, I know, it's awesome. Yay. Of course he did. We're going to get a full story.
Stuck playing Mario Brothers.
We'll be right back.
Welcome back. This is your Feel Good Breakfast Show Expresso right here on SABC3. Man, we have two cool stories for you right now on the tech front.
We do.
Man.
The first being for all parents out there who think that video gaming is a complete waste of time. Well, listen to this. Just yesterday, some guy called J1, a professional player of the popular PC game Overwatch, reportedly signed a new contract with NRG Esports team for $150,000. What makes this even more interesting is that his mother had to sign the contract because he's 17 years old. So according to the law of the country, he's still a minor. So mommy still had to be there to help him. But if you want to place this into a South African context, it's the equivalent of about 2 million rand in salary every year. And this is without any bonuses for winning tournaments, any shares or revenue that might be later on generated by the team. So this is really, really amazing. The field has actually been blown quite open.
It's a whole new kind of direction that things are taking. Because, you know, all I can say now is, Kian, as ek by die huis kom vanmiddag, is that ek yank games. Ons gaan games speel van nou aan. That's what we're doing, you know.
And the more exciting thing is that there's talks right now to put esports as an official sport of the Olympics. So that could just paint a whole different picture. People are saying that the industry will generate some $1 billion by 2020 in revenue.
That is crazy, man. What? That is crazy. Gaming. You know, we love it. We love it. Okay, well, anyways, here's another interesting question. I'm sure that you ask yourself quite often as well, but are you tired of waiting for taxis and sitting in traffic?
Yes, of course, we all are.
Now, a German startup company called Lilium just secured a $90 million investment. That's almost 1.2 billion rand to design a 5-seater electric flying taxi, okay? Mm. And this follows their successful test run earlier this year of a 2-seater version of a similar concept. And it has this vertical kind of takeoff and landing. It can reach speeds of up to 300 kilometers an hour. It's also completely emission free, which I think is amazing.
Wow.
Which makes it, and also makes virtually no noise whatsoever. So basically, in the future, I mean, they hope to implement a similar system to current on demand taxis, but with a flying craft. I think, can you imagine that, man? What a world like that would look like. I mean, they really hope that the first full functional jet will take off by 2019, which is literally just around the corner. And by 2025, they hope that an on-demand service similar to Uber will be a reality.
I will only book it if the drivers have names like Passionate, Dedicated, Integrity, Loving.
Or get you there safely. I don't know, man. But particularly that you're right on its way, you look to the skies for once. I mean, that is crazy. So anyway, some cool tech stories this morning, man.
Absolutely.
Oh, well, listen, we are now turning our attention to the music front. And the question is, who will be the top performing South African act on this week's 5FM Top 40? Both Mikasa and Shekinah are currently in the top 10. Carl Watson currently climbing the charts. But here's Nick Hammond.
Nick Hammond, live from the Hammond Time Heritage Tour. So please excuse the beard. Back with another recap of the 5FM Top 40, looking at the biggest hits from this past weekend. And like we do every week, let's begin by looking at the brand new entries onto the charts. And speaking of which, at number 35, it's finally on Bruno Mars, Versace on the Floor. Versace on the Floor. The second new entry pick I went for this week came in at number 23. It's Ladies of Mars' follow-up single to Criminal, this one called My Baby. Alright, it's time to check out the Mover and Shaker picks for the week. These are songs that have either re-entered onto the chart, so I believe might even go all the way to number one. The first one this week that I've picked is a re-entry. It's at number 25. It's from his brand new EP that's out and available, full album in fact. Dominic Neal is his name. The track at 25 this week, re-entry, it's called Out of My League. Out of my league, you are out of my league. My second Mover and Shaker pick this week went from number 22 to number 18. It's huge all over the world. J Balvin and Willie Williams. It's called Minion. Estamos rompiendo la discoteca. La fiesta no para pena comienza. Time to check out the top 10 biggest songs in music for this past week. Starting at number 10, dropping from, or climbing in fact, from the last week's number 13. It's music from James Blunt and Robin Schulz. Okay. It's gonna be number 9 this week, also the highest entry onto the charts, it's Justin Bieber and Blood Pop called New Friends. Can we still be friends? This week, staying steady at number 8, dropping from just number 7 the week before, it's Niall Horan and Slow Hands. Sitting at number 7, it's Katy Perry, Big Sean, Pharrell, and Calvin Harris with Fears. Baby, I know you ain't scared of second highest local entry onto the charts this week at number 6 is Chicana with Suit. Coming in at number 5 this week on the charts, it's the first single from their brand new album, Mikasa. I've got one for you called Nana. She's finally back, and it's great to see her on 5FM and on the charts again. Sitting at number 4 this week, it's Pink with a tune called What About Us. What about us? What about all the times you said you had the answer? Staying steady on the charts for yet another week in a row at number 3 this week, Swae Lee and French Montana with Unforgettable. Sitting just at the number 2 spot this week, it's Rihanna, Bryson Tiller, and DJ Khaled with Wild Thoughts. When I was you, all I get is wild thoughts. Wow, wow, wow. Wow, wow, wild thoughts. Thanks so much for watching, guys. Make sure to catch me, Nick Hammond, Monday to Friday, 9 to 12 on Hammond Time, as all of this month we continue the Hammond Time Heritage Tour. And of course, 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. on 5FM to listen to the top 40 to find out which tune will land up in the number 1 spot. Speaking of which, this past weekend, yet again, it went to Justin Bieber, Luis Fonsi, and Daddy Yankee. Despacito. Quiero desnudarte a besos despacito. Firma las paredes de tu laberinto. Y hacer de tu cuerpo todo un manuscrito. Sube, sube, sube. Sube, sube. Quiero ver bailar tu pelo. This song is going to be there for a while, man.
I love it.
Hey? Chicky-chicky getting into it this morning. Loving it. Hey? Loving it, loving it. Anyway, so from great music right now, it is time to make your day. All right, so it's not the first time you're hearing about this, but it really is exciting because Vodacom is offering customers a chance to explore more of the internet with up to 1 gig free data every single day. Now, today is Gaming Wednesday, and you can get free access for the day to GameMind, VooClip, and also Vodacom games without any data charges. So with all of the gamers in studio today, I thought, you know, we would find out a little bit more about their views on mobile gaming. And we have Robin Ryle here this morning, two of our gamers who's been on there racing their hearts out. How are you doing, gents?
All good, guys.
You guys even answered at the same time.
It's like, wow.
Now, if you thought you were seeing double, you're not. They're actually twins, and it's really good to have you guys here. Well, I want to ask you, when you don't have access to a console or maybe a computer, is mobile gaming the thing that gives you that fix that you still need?
Yes, definitely, because when I'm always on the go and always needing my cell phone, so whenever I ever needed to play any games, my cell phone will come in handy. And games is always free because you have to always have to plug consoles in,
true
computers.
Story.
You understand?
Yeah.
So when you have your phone, you can anywhere access anywhere. You know, you can always play the games. They're awesome.
And I mean, there's some pretty cool games out there.
Yeah,
you can take a look at the mobile games. Like, we played some of them on the show as well, and they are amazing. So I think, Roman, I mean, what are some of your favorite, like, online mobile games?
There's quite a few, but at the moment, I have three favorites. It's called Cut the Rope, and then there's another one called Pet Something. Like, I don't know, you have to do something or make pets and stuff. And my least favorite, or to say my very favorite, let's put it like that, it is called Blop. Blop is basically a game, basically you have to try to pop as much bubbles as possible in 20 seconds.
Wow. Okay. So you look like a madman on your phone, I guess.
Like literally like going on and on.
Okay.
And then, of course, with the constant developments in technology and content, is mobile gaming something that's becoming more and more popular?
Yes. Every day, it's always growing to expand the mobile capability for mobiles. They're always willing to give new games for their people, their clients on their phone.
Awesome.
And as well, you're getting free games to download every day. And Vodacom is giving an awesome deal for 1 gigabyte of data, and you can play anywhere you know. One of the top games at the market at the moment is Pokemon Go, Pokemon Go has reached up to the first 9 days of launch. It reached up to 1 billion hits.
What?
So that's kind of amazing. That's kind of awesome.
That is crazy, man. Yeah. But really some cool games. I'm a big fan of Cut the Rope as well. You know,
yeah, same here.
That is
same
great.
Recently downloaded.
Keeps you entertained. Listen, guys, thank you very much. And all the best for the gaming tournament still going on.
Thanks.
I don't know what is happening there, but you guys look like you are taking it very, very seriously. But at the end of the day, to make your day, simply keep a positive data balance on your Vodacom SIM card. Then dial *111*634#, or you can just download the latest version of the My Vodacom app and claim your free data daily. It's as easy as that. But for more info and T's and C's, you can visit the website vodacom.co.za.
I have to make a confession. What? Those mobile games, they are addictive.
Are you a crusher?
I am a candy crusher. We're going to take a quick break on your Feel Good Breakfast show. When we get back, it's your international entertainment news and people are getting hitched.
Yeah, and then we also find out the story of a regular guy who won a competition that allowed him to choose between learning to do something new or getting a complete makeover. This is the guy I'm talking about. You'll see him on your screen very shortly, but we'll find out what he chose and what the results thereof were. Take a look at that after the break, so stay tuned to your Feel Good Breakfast show.
To celebrate the 10th anniversary of a direct flight between Cape Town and Istanbul, Turkish Airlines has a special gift for you. Flying direct from Cape Town, enjoy a stopover in Istanbul and get complimentary accommodation while you take in the spectacular views, incredible food, and do a tour or two before making your way to your destination. It's the perfect break on your travel adventure. So come and enjoy the country known for its hospitality and good food like I did. Turkish Airlines, widen your world.
It's my Feel Good Breakfast Show. Welcome back. This is your Feel Good Breakfast Show. Time for us to now turn our attention to what our international stars have been up to.
Well, one of my favorite actors, Michael Fassbender, and Alicia Vikander have been one of our favorite couples for a while, and it seems they're taking that next step. So according to multiple sources, the acting duo, who have been dating for 3 years, are rumored to be tying the knot next month. And while full details have yet to be revealed and confirmed, rumor has it that the nuptials will take place in Spain and that Michael is sparing no expense for Alicia. A Hollywood hottie and a wedding without a price limit sounds fantastic to me.
Yeah,
we sign
up. Just a blank check.
Also,
hey, honey, do
also,
whatever you want.
Also, like 3 years, right? Because he was making sure.
Yes.
Like, sure, you must be sure. 3 years.
Okay. Especially being with Alicia, you have to be sure.
Hey, 3 years, you see.
Well, from a couple...
The 10,000 hour rule.
Well, from a couple rumored to be tying the knot to one that actually is, remember Holly Marie Combs from that show Charmed?
Yes.
Yes.
She was so cute.
I know, hey. Well, the actress is set to get married. So via Instagram, Holly shared a photo of her new ring, which we can only say is wow. Zahir. Wow. Amazing. You?
Ooh la la.
That is very charmed indeed.
I love the black nail polish. It's very charmed indeed.
That ring looks
Zoe
like
looks
it possesses...
at the nail polish. We're looking at the ring.
Like Zoe.
Okay.
Zoe.
Well, Holly has been married twice before, but seeming that things didn't work out, or rather that things rather work out in threes, as we saw in the show Charmed, perhaps this is a third time lucky. So congratulations to the happy couple and the soon-to-be married couple, and everybody's just in love.
Yeah,
I
man.
Love that they're in love. And I just want to say happy birthday to Idris Elba.
Well, I was going to say it's spring.
You know, whenever you do that, Leanne, this song always comes up in my mind. Everybody has a dream.
Yes.
And we all have a right to learn.
That's love. We all have a right to love.
No, to learn.
Okay.
To learn. All right. Now, ladies, listen. Listen. If you could choose if you want a competition, you had the choice between learning to do something new or getting a complete makeover. Which would you choose?
Maybe a makeover.
Makeover.
Makeover, yes.
Makeover. What? Makeover. Okay. Yes. Makeovers are also allowed. Okay. But one lucky winner of the Woolworths and UCount Rewards competition was given that freedom, and we get to spend the day with them to see what they chose and what those results were.
I'm Luke Davies, living in Cape Town, 38 years old, working an office job. Enjoy outdoor activities and, you know, a bit of the outdoor life, walking the dog. That's me, looking forward to this experience. I feel great about winning. I feel surprised still, feel spoiled, and excited to see how the look's going to be afterwards. I'm just open to changing the wardrobe a bit and freshening up the look. When I'm in the office, I'm not really making much of an effort, so just to see how I can be my best self day to day, you know.
Luke's wife often encourages him to try stylish new items, but today he'll be guided by stylist Adil Desai and Woolworths menswear senior designer Ibrahim Adams.
What I'm looking to show you today is how we play around with different trends in the different departments and how we can best find a look that suits you.
I need to know what you'd like to achieve from all of this and what your current style is.
Current style would probably be classic conventional menswear and looking for some ideas on how to spruce that up a little bit.
Being springtime, is there any key transseasonal item that you'd like to find today?
Yeah, I've been thinking around the idea of maybe jackets, you know, something that I can just play with and dress up with, dress down with, and see what we can do with that.
I think he was looking for a look that could change him, but still show who he was as a person. We wanted to open his eyes up to what the potential was that on the floor, that the garments could offer him. What I really like about this is it talks back to the whole utilitarian trend.
This season's field jacket, it's about the four pockets, and you can see that the scale of these pockets are a lot larger than they were previous seasons. We can see that there's the draw cord functionality, which allows you to accentuate the waist and give you more of a cleaner, sharp shoulder.
There's also another hidden gem here, which is a concealed hood.
They're really good. They picked up on what I felt comfortable with, but also challenged me where they could, and just showed me that one or two final little touches is what really makes an outfit stand out. So that was good to learn.
Let's show you one of my favorite item blazers for the season. It's a linen cotton blend. The textures are just incredible. It's soft.
Texture is very key for the season. So we're looking at a herringbone texture on this item blazer, pairing it up with new styling. So we're looking at the patch pockets over conventional flap pockets for the season.
Oh, this is definitely something I'd like to try out, guys. It's something that I think would work for me.
And then to take you even one step further, it's a more tailored version of the parka field jacket.
He's open to everything we give him, and then also the feedback that we got from him. I think that was really good.
That he had an opinion, you know, that we weren't bulldozing him, but he bounced ideas back at us. Two key items in footwear this season, I would definitely say, are the loafers and...
The season's monk strap is about the double buckle and the toe cap detail. All of these shoes are genuine leather, and it's paired back quite easily to a suit, but what we're looking at this season is about pairing it with denim jeans and the item blazer.
Let's actually put on all these items and let's have fun.
Once we showed him some of the modern aspects to clothing and fashion and how to dress them differently, I think that's also what sort of brought him to life, and he was quite surprised and really liked that look the best, I think.
So, we start off with the utilitarian look. Don't be afraid to always push up your sleeves, okay? Right. Make the jacket feel like it's yours. And then another thing, don't be afraid to tuck in, because it just gives me the illusion that your waist actually sits up here and it elongates your leg. There was a reaction. The softness of garments, the way it made him feel.
And it was a positive reaction with every change, which was amazing.
Oh, cool. So how do you feel, Luke?
Completely different. Yeah, the shirt just adds a nice little bit of an extra layer to the look. And then the cap was a great advice.
What's your take on the shoe? Because you'd normally only wear it with a suit.
It's taking me from, you know, just your basic office wear to even going out with. So I'm enjoying it. I think it's a great fit for me. I think it's just been a few final touches that they've shown me work for me within my comfort zone, but still taking a few chances.
The key item over here is the item blazer, paired back with a clean salvage denim, the simple white sneakers, and then the indigo t-shirt. So it's something you could wear to the office and to the bar comfortably.
I agree, yeah. It's a very comfortable and versatile look, and I'm enjoying it. Thanks.
It's been eye-opening, but overall very enjoyable. It's been nice to have just that little bit of input that you wouldn't normally get on your average shop. So thanks to the guys.
After an amazing day of shopping and learning great styling tips, it's time for Luke's big makeover reveal.
I think they can expect somebody who's really more confident. I mean, when we met him, he had a small smile. Once we dressed him in his final reveal look, it was even huger, that smile. It's got a classic yet sporty feel to it, and spot on. What's your
spot on trend? I love it.
Luke's goal was to take his look to the next level, and he's ready to strut his fresh new style.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, take a look at the new look! Give a round of applause! Yes! Strut your stuff down that carpet, boy. Cover the swag, cover the combination, give us a twirl, all of that. Yes, boom, boom. The camera loves you, Luke. Come over here, man. Come over here and join us here. And sitting next to me is also Luke's wife, Shanaz Khaland. Thanks very much for being here, guys. Luke! Congratulations, man.
Thanks so much, man. Yeah, it's been quite a ride, quite an enjoyable experience, and this moment's just been great, so thank you.
How does it feel, the new look? And you can be completely, completely honest with me.
I missed the outfit. I tried it on, obviously, at Woolworths, and it felt good that day, but it feels 10 times better today. I love being in it.
The process of having your own personal stylist there advising you on all the different elements of your style, what was that like for you, spending the day there?
It was fantastic, eye-opening, obviously. Learned a lot about myself and obviously fashion too. I walk away with it with a lot of ideas just to, you know, go and use when I go and shop again. So yeah, it was great. Eh?
Yeah. And Shanaz, of course I've got to get an opinion from you. Yeah. What do you think of hubby's new look, and what have you made of, like, what did this do for him personally, do you think?
I think he looks great, first of all. This is a new kind of style for him. I mean, Luke works in accounts and billing. So this
an
is
accountant.
Like, yeah. So this is like a totally different kind of look for him, and we're just grateful for the opportunity. And it did a lot for his confidence, and he found it exciting, and it was great to get two specialists really to help with the look. So we're just thankful for it, and it's good.
Do you see the biggest smile that they were talking about that he now has?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, absolutely.
Dude, I'm loving it, man. I'm hoping that it's going to inspire a new side of you and just see you enjoying life so much more. Congratulations on the win.
Thank you so much, man. And thanks to Woolworths and all the guys involved, Expresso. Really worthwhile, enjoyable experience. Thanks, guys. Yeah.
We're just appreciating, this is you before.
And is that me?
Don't even recognize yourself, man. And that's what you look like right now. But guess what, guys? Mm-hmm. There is more.
Is it?
I've always wanted to do that. There's more. Listen, as a part of the prize, you've also now won a 5,000 Rand Woolworths gift card to go and do some shopping at Woolies.
Nice.
And you also will be staying for 2 nights at the wonderful Arabella Hotel and Spa.
Oh, wow.
Can we give that a round of applause, guys? Come on. Yes.
Thank you.
Kiss your wife on national TV, Luke. Tell them out there. Congratulations to you.
Thank
that's
you
amazing.
So much. Thanks.
Amazing
news. Well done. Thank you to our friends at Woolworths for making this possible.
All right, so our semi-finals have arrived. Playing for that 27-inch QLED curved gaming monitor, our gamers have been put through their paces, and now we have reached our first two semi-finalists. It's all going down after the break.
Yeah, man, it's very exciting. I just want to have a turn on this, man. That's all I want to do. Listen, we're also going to have a brilliant performance coming up again from KhoisanBoy.Man. All right, very interesting. KhoisanBoy.Man. Very interesting indeed. But he is phenomenal. Don't miss that performance after the break.
Lightning fall.
Welcome back. You're live with Expresso on a beautiful Wednesday morning. We've entered into the knockout stages. Well, it's all been knockout, but now it's into the semis. It's just got real. We've got Robin, of course, who beat Jonathan earlier, posting a time of 2:24. And we've got Gia, who beat Ella. He posted a time of 2:29. Gentlemen, are you ready as our first semi-finalists? Let's take it away. 3, 2, 1. Go, boys. Come on now. Racing two classics. We've got a Honda. We've got a Golf. And of course, now the fastest lap time here. So we're going to give them a couple of laps. It's going to go up against Rael. Could it be brother against brother? Yeah, it's going to be epic. So I don't want to call you the loser's corner, because that just sounds awful, okay? So you're the not winners this morning, guys. I know we took you out of your comfort zone this morning. I have to ask, because this I'm not like a full-on gamer, but this makes you want to convert. Ella, what was it like playing on the screen? Champ, get over it, girl. Come on, you've had like an hour to get over the loss now. Still burning.
Apart from losing so bad.
Oh, it's still burning.
Funny thing is though, I kind of got the hang of it after it was done, so I'm technically not a loser, but
well, anyway. Exactly. I like your logic. I mean, 49 inches, this is a beast. From a gaming right. perspective, this has got to be a game changer.
It's like, honestly, half an inch of a television. It's like two monitors put into one. The resolution is quite great. The interface as well is very smooth for gaming. The graphics are impeccable.
Yeah, I know. It's
it is honestly a great experience. I don't know if you guys feel the same.
I concur. I agree with her. It's really amazing. And not just that, it's like watching a TV basically as well. So it's really nice, not just for gaming purposes.
It feels like VR, because wherever you turn, there's a screen. It doesn't matter. Your neck actually gets sore. But guys, thank you so much. I'm sorry that we can't give you that beautiful QLED gaming monitor, the CFG70, valued at around 10 grand. Not a bad prize, but you still stand chance of winning it. Come on. So our semi-finalists, we're going to bring you an update of their fastest score. But please, guys, remember, you at home have an opportunity to win and win big. We've got a 24-inch QLED curved gaming monitor give to you. Go to our Facebook page right now to get all the details.
Hey, right now, time for us to enjoy some music from KhoisanBoy.Man, a man whose latest offering called The Infinity Dialogue is out and available for online download. And he's sharing that music with us this morning. And here he is performing one of his tracks called Still Wide Awake.
Lightning form, I've never known home. Burn so bright, shine a light, and maybe we'll find somewhere beautiful to call home. Forever we roam. Still wide awake, still wide awake, come on, I'm still wide awake, go. Still wide awake, come on, I'm still wide awake. Still wide awake, come on, I'm still wide awake, go. Still wide awake, come on now. I found my form. I've never left home. Now I know that maybe I'm all I need now. Finding miracles in my bones. Forever we grow. Wide awake, come on, I'm still wide awake, go. Still Still wide awake, come on, I'm still wide awake. Still wide awake, come on, I'm still wide awake. Still wide awake, come on, I'm so much more.
Boy Man on your feel good breakfast show. Nice one, brother. Nice one. I'm sure there's many people watching this right now wondering, the Khoisan Boy Man, explain that.
Well, with this being Heritage Month and all, I think I started doing a little bit of digging about where it is that I'm coming from. And I think the idea of just being Khoi or San and being original from this land is an important thing to get to know.
Yeah. And then is that a transition from boyhood to manhood?
Okay. I think in the grander scheme of things, I'm still a boy learning and becoming a man.
Speaking of which, what can people expect from the Infinity Dialogue, which is your EP that's available for download right now?
I think what they can expect is honesty. And it's a lot of what I've been through, particularly over the last 2 years. Just with facing the idea of mortality or just identity and love.
Fantastic stuff. Well, thank you for sharing the music with us. We really do appreciate it. Follow the man on social media. In fact, link up with us on social media, Expresso Morning Show, SABC3. That is our Facebook page, and let us know what you thought of his music.
In die nasionale nuus, motoriste sal van vandag af 67 sent per liter meer vir petrol en 44 sent per liter meer vir diesel moet opdok. Die verhoging is te wyte aan die verswakking van die rand teenoor die dollar, as ook die hoër pryse van brandstof op internasionale markte. Openbare vervoer sal uiteraard ook deur die verhogings geraak word. Gebruikers van busse en taksies moet kennis neem dat tariefverhogings binnekort aan die orde van die dag sal wees. Statistiek Suid-Afrika het bekend gemaak dat Suid-Afrika met 'n toename van 2.5% in sy bruto binnelandse produk gedurende van jaar se tweede kwartaal hom uit die tegniese resessie losgemaak het. Die statistiek-generaal Palile Hogla het gister op 'n nuuskonferensie in Pretoria die tweede kwartaal se BBP-syfers bekend gemaak. Hogla het gesê die ekonomie het kwartaal na kwartaal sowel as jaar na jaar met onderskeidelik 2.5% en 1.1% gegroei. Op die internasionale front, orkaan Irma het tot 'n uiters gevaarlike kategorie 5 storm verhewig en noodtoestande is in Puerto Rico, die Magte Eilande en Florida in die VSA afgekondig. Verskeie eilande in die Karibiese See maak gereed vir moontlike lewensbedreigende wind, erge storms en reën oor die volgende 24 uur. Irma se roete oor die volgende ruk kan nog nie presies uitgestippel word nie, maar die suide van Florida gaan waarskynlik binnekort getref word. En dan ten slotte, Vladimir Putin meen nuwe sanksies teen Noord-Korea sal nutteloos en ondoeltreffend wees. Die Russiese president het gesê strenger sanksies teen die regime van Kim Jong-un
weens sy kernmissielprogram sal nie die bewind in Pyongyang verander nie. Hy meen dit kan tot grootskaalse menslike lyding lei. Putin het na afloop van die onlangse BRICS-spitsberaad in China gepraat en Noord-Korea se optrede verdoem. Hy het dit as uittartend gemaak en teen militêre hysterie gewaarsku wat 'n globale ramp kan veroorsaak. Well, that was your 8 o'clock news update. Here's a final look at what's happening in the world of sport.
Football first this morning at Bafana Bafana's crest for the 2018 World Cup qualification received yet another blow last night as they fell to Cape Verde in Durban. The 2-1 defeat now leaves South Africa bottom of Group D on 4 points with two rounds of fixtures remaining. In the other African qualifying results from last night, Egypt beat Uganda 1-0. Ghana, they earned a 5-1 win over the Congo, while Burkina Faso and Senegal played out to a thrilling 2-2 draw. Then Spain were in goal-scoring form, to say the least, last night as they put 8 unanswered goals past Liechtenstein in their European 2018 World Cup qualifying campaign. Alvaro Morata and Iago Aspas both hitting the back of the net twice as the 2010 World Cup winners kept their 3-point lead at the top of Group G. Elsewhere, Wales earned a 2-0 win over Moldova. Austria and Georgia drew 1-1, while Italy, they beat Israel by 1-0. Then on to cycling. Team Sky's Chris Froome extended his overall lead in the Vuelta a España yesterday as he cruised to victory in the Stage 16 time trial. Froome clocking in 47 minutes for the 40.2-kilometer stage, finishing 29 seconds ahead of his nearest competitor, Wilco Kelderman. So on the overall standings now, yesterday's win saw Froome move on to 1 minute and 58 seconds ahead of second-placed Vincenzo Nibali with 5 stages remaining. Now back to the US Open. Pablo Carreño Busta booked his place in the last four of the US Open last night as he beats Diego Schwartzman in the quarterfinals. So the straight sets win sees the 26-year-old Spaniard progress to a Grand Slam semi-final for the first time in his career after 16 previous attempts. In some other quarterfinal results from last night, Sloane Stephens downed Anastasia Sevetsova, whilst Venus Williams, she beat Petra Kvitova. But the big news in right now, literally just a few seconds ago, the big serving Kevin Anderson, he beat American Sam Querrey to progress to the semi-finals of the US Open, probably the biggest step that he has taken in his career. Can I get a cheer? Thank you so much. Well done to Kevin Anderson. And if ever there was an opportunity to win it, his big serving is possibly the chance to beat some of the best players in the world. So we are sending all of our congratulations to the US. Well done.
Well, on that note, let's take a final look at your traffic. We start off in Gauteng, Johannesburg. Now, there's been a serious minibus taxi accident on Louis Botha Avenue in the Orange Grove area, and half the wall, well, a wall has also collapsed there, so you can't expect further delays. Then staying in Gauteng, there's also another accident on the R101 southbound before Olifantsfontein Road. The left shoulder is blocked, so please approach with caution. Well, that's where we leave your traffic on your Feel Good Breakfast Show.
It's a bottom of the night. Let's quickly take a last look at your weather here on your Feel Good Wednesday morning. And it looks like most parts of the country can expect partly cloudy conditions. And then there's some rain expected in parts of the Eastern Cape today. Your temperature for the last keer vandag, Polokwane, skop af op 10 grade minimum and a maximum 28. Mbombela 13 and a warm 33. Later vandag, Pretoria 13, 28. Johannesburg 12, 27. Mahikeng 12, 30. Klerksdorp 12, 29. Kimberley 9 grade minimum and a maximum 29, Bloemfontein 7, 27, Richards Bay begin op 16, dit styg na 25 grade, Pietermaritzburg 13, 26, Durban 18, 24, Mthatha begin op 10 grade minimum en 'n maximum 22, West-London 15, 20, Craddock begin op 11 grade minimum en 'n maximum van 'n warm 30, Port Elizabeth on 13 this morning, maximum 20, George 10, 20, Sutherland a cool 3 degrees minimum, staying cool with a maximum 16, Cape Town 12, 16, Worcester 6.18, Springbok 1.18 and Upington on 9 degrees minimum with a maximum 28 degrees. That's a wrap of your weather here on your Feel Good Wednesday on your Feel Good Breakfast Show.
So the moment has finally arrived, the moment of truth. If you've been watching this morning, you would have seen some battle royale taking place here on our beautiful 49-inch QLED Samsung gaming monitor. It really is a game changer, man. You're going to look, whoa, you're going to hurt your neck to see the whole thing. But of course, we've had all of our gamers here. Guys, thank you so much for joining us this morning. Competing for their own slice of heaven, a 27-inch QLED gaming monitor. And we've now reached our final. It's brother versus brother. We're causing a rift in the family. Robin and Rael, you guys have done it. You clocked some insane times as well. So I'm really looking forward to this. So gentlemen, without further ado, take it away. This is to decide our ultimate gaming champion this morning on Forza 6. 2-1. Gentlemen, take it away. Oh, I love it, man. Oh, someone changed their view already. We've gone with two old school cars. I like that. I have a feeling these guys might have played this before, man. Easy, losers. Easy. I have to ask you, brother. As a gamer, as an avid gamer, this screen has got to excite you, man.
Absolutely. Well, you know, usually when people come and they're approaching a new screen, they have like difficulty approaching it, but because the latency is so low in the screen, it's actually really fantastic. It feels really natural. The colors really pop at you as well, so it's a really fantastic screen.
Oh, it's awesome, and I'll give you an opportunity once this is done and dusted to play a little bit of Witcher 3 to see a different atmospheric game, just how far you can take the graphic capabilities here. So, but guys, thank you so much. You're all worthy competitors. Give yourselves a pat on the back as you stroke the pups. So the big news is, guys, you at home also have an opportunity to win. We'll be announcing our winner on Friday, but you'll see we brought two monitors in here. Why? Because we want to give a 24-inch QLED gaming monitor to you. And what you've got to do is get to our Facebook page. You've got to tell us what feature about this beast of gaming technology excites you most. Is it the resolution, which is phenomenal? Is it just the sheer awesomeness of the size? And it is the biggest on the market. Let us know on our Expresso Morning Show Facebook page. And make it creative, because we've had a ton of really good entries coming in already. And we'll give those details throughout the week and on Friday announce our winner. But right now it's all going down on our track. I see brother versus brother. I often think that they share one mind, and they're both two of the nicest guys. Okay, there's been no smack talk. I really feel that they've approached this as gentlemen. It's a gentleman sport. Laugh, come on, man. Grab the microphone.
I think they're both respecting each other, because the moment they get home, I feel like the other one is going to be like, what did you say?
That's when it's going to happen. Oh, I love it. Wanda, are you still burning over getting given the wrong controls?
Not really. I already asked Robin for a rematch. Either way, if one of them wins, it's going to be.
And then we're playing for street cred. Then we are playing for bragging rights.
It's on.
Oh, yeah. Oh, boys, it looks like you've both actually really got a handle on this. You're not out of sight, dude. You're not out of sight. Come on, get in there. Put your racing gloves on. And they both are actually wearing racing gloves as well, which is insane. Have we clocked you? You're in second place. You're in first. Come on, Rael. I don't think one of you has gone off track. Oh, no, I've ruined it. I jinxed it. Come on. We've got... Oh, man. So we're going to let them finish off their final lap. We're going to bring you the results. Our grand prize winner is going to walk away with that insane gaming monitor after the break. Oh. Come on.
Wow, man. Okay.
So much adrenaline in this car.
So much
right
adrenaline.
Right in there.
Let's take a breather quickly. We're going to take a quick ad break. And in light of the Cape Town water crisis that we're having, a brand new campaign has emerged, H2Zero. Very cool, inspiring you to use less water, and that through chefs. Very cool. We'll find you out a little bit more after the break.
Very cool stuff. And also, we are continuing our journey in revealing the celebrity contestants that will be taking part in hashtag TIOT8. I'm, of course, talking about Tropical Island of Treasure, Maldives. Yesterday was Kanya. Who will it be today? Stay tuned.
When you feed your dog's health, you also feed his happiness. And wonderful things can happen. Like he's able to go from zero to boundless get up and go. And a fluffier coat unlocks maximum cuddle potential. Because you're feeding the clinically proven nutrition of Hill's Science Plan. Precisely prepared with top quality ingredients. After all, when he's healthier, he's happier. And a dog's tail never lies. Give him the science of happy, found in the brand recommended by vets worldwide.
Welcome back. You're tuned into your Feel Good Breakfast Show. This is Expresso only on SABC3. Hope you're enjoying this Wednesday morning with us. Well, it's a rather interesting Wednesday at that as well. Now, this morning we are joined by Mike, who is the Chief Creative Officer at 140 BBDO, the agency that came up with the amazing H20 campaign. And that's through challenging renowned chefs to create menus that are entirely waterless. And he hopes to inspire the rest of us to try and do the same at home. And we're also joined by one of the Wednesday Waterless Warriors this morning, Franck Dangereaux, who's not been in the kitchen for forever, man. How's it going, brother?
Good, you?
Mike, how's it going, my friend?
Oh, good, thanks.
Lovely to see you. Look, let's talk about this campaign, H20. I think it's phenomenal, you know, with the water crisis that's staring us in the face here in Cape Town. H20, take us back to what inspired this campaign in the first place.
Well, I think we have a water crisis out there, and I think the way we've tackled it, we need some more creative solutions to the problem. Like, it's been a little bit too obvious, flushing toilets, all this kind of thing. Let's think beyond in a creative way. And we thought H20, let's look at a more fun, imaginative way to inspire people out there. There are other ways of saving water. We need to really look around us. And this is one of the ways, thinking out of the box, out of the pan. We've got the celebrity chefs on board.
I love it.
Which is fantastic. And, you know, it's just to get people out there to think differently.
Yeah, so Franck, you are here to make a kind of a waterless seared tuna dish. Now, I want to just unpack, how will this now work going forward with specifically chefs like Franck?
Well, I think the key is to get chefs, you know, that have a high profile, you know, that have the cred out there, to get people thinking in their kitchens and to come up with these menus that'll be downloaded. Smile FM have now started this initiative, launching this morning. On Waterless Wednesday, so you kind of get out there and start thinking. Now, Waterless Wednesday, it stimulates you to, and the menus you guys are going to come up with, show people how to do it, and hopefully a book even comes out with waterless
recipes. Let's see where it can go, man. Let's see if we can all pull together. Now, you stick around for this delicious recipe. Franck, take us through this recipe. Let's put it together.
Okay, so we've got yellowfin tuna, which is a sustainable fish as well. Vegetables that you can buy. You don't have to wash them because they normally come out of a clean packet. Just brush them off a little bit.
Okay.
And then basically what we do is, we put a bit of oil on the tuna and oil on the vegetables.
That's a great piece of tuna, man.
Yeah, it's a beautiful piece of tuna, isn't it?
Ooh.
So you must oil the fish a little bit so that it doesn't stick to the grill.
Okay.
And then first I'm going to put the veg on. So salt. Crush some salt on the vegetables.
Right.
And some pepper. And then I just want to toss a little bit of oil in those guys. Then you put those on the griddle.
All right.
So they take a little while, but we've got some that are cooked already.
That's okay, but I mean, I love the fact that you're keeping it simple with this, yet you're using the natural kind of flavors of the ingredients.
It has to be simple.
Put
the griddle on. So basically this is on. Yeah, you know, if you come to think about it, we actually, 80% of the food we cook is actually waterless. We fry a lot, deep fry, grill, braai. I mean, September is braai month. We're going to use September to use your braai as much as possible, often as possible.
All right. Well, that's pretty easy. I love it.
So basically now
the
veggies are cooked, half cherry tomatoes in there. You got a little bit of fresh coriander that's been chopped.
Brilliant.
So always remember to put a little bit more seasoning in there. And then I made a dressing basically with soy sauce, olive oil, in a jam jar, put some chili in there.
Which will go amazing with the fish.
And then basically we just squeeze a bit of lime juice in there. If you want, if you have time, or if you really like the strong flavor of lime, you can actually grate the rind in there as well.
All right, well, there we have it. If you want to get your hands on the recipe to our seared tuna dish this morning, SMS the keyword fish to 33728. Fish is the keyword, or lunch, excuse me. Lunch is the keyword to 33728. That's lunch to 33728, and you can get your hands on the recipe. Check it out on our website a little bit later on as well. But it's smelling so fresh, dude. This is what I love about this recipe. Very, very cool.
Just put that on, and then by the time you're done, your tuna will be ready. And then all you got to do...
So for the tuna, I mean, you don't want to completely overcook it. You basically just want to sear it.
You just want to sear it, so it's on and off, yeah.
That's it. Man, we're getting spoiled for breakfast this morning, Mike. How's that?
Basically, those little veggies are just being...
Awesome,
turn them like that. This guy...
Oh, and look at that.
Just like that. So basically, this one was grilled a few seconds before. And then you serve that, so you put the third slice on, and then, you know, you can actually finish it off with a little bit of that gorgeous dressing on the plate like that.
And look at that, eh? Our Waterless Wednesday hero this morning. Okay, fine, you can just give it to me. I'll say it's breakfast. There we go. Keep it as lunch. SMS that to 33728. Franck, lovely to see you, man. Welcome back.
See you too. Thank you.
And Mike, we're going to find out a little bit more about that campaign in just a second. We've got Pete Goffe-Wood with us in studio with a lacquer steak recipe. Don't miss it.
Oh, right now it's all about T-I-O-T-8, baby. Tropical Island of Treasure. And it's that time again for us to reveal yesterday's clue
yes.
as to who the next celebrity contestant is who'll be hotting it up on the latest season of Tropical Island of Treasure. And if you didn't get yesterday's clue, let me repeat it to you again. It sounded like this. Stop, wait, stay a little bit. This hashtag no excuses 21-year-old heartthrob is almost as good with a rugby ball as he is with a guitar. Who is he? Were you able to guess it right?
Can we have a drum roll?
Drum roll, please.
Please. Oh, it's Brandon Paper, everybody.
Yay!
Yes.
There he is. There
look
he is.
Him.
He is our next celebrity contestant.
Mara Andrik, look at you, Manda.
Yeah, yeah, met the part pigs work.
Liar, liar. Well, congratulations to all of you who got that correct. And of course, it is Brandon Paper. He is the second celebrity contestant on hashtag TIOT8. And he'll be serenading all the ladies on the island. Keep checking in for daily celeb clues, and you could win a golden ticket to the auditions. Hashtag TIOT8. 5 more golden tickets are up for grabs.
Introducing Tropical Island of Treasure Maldives celebrity contestant, sexy Afrikaans singer Brendan Paper.
Brendan, hoe gaan het met jou?
Goed en jij?
Lekker man. Zo zeg ik mij, waar leer jouw vlak van opgewondenheid als het komt bij die feit dat jij deel is van Tropical Island of Treasure seizoen 8?
Ik ben wel opgewonden, het is mijn eerste keer oor see. En ik weet dat die Maldives is maar een plek waar mensen, je weet, mensen moeten daar toe gaan voor honeymoon of zo. En het is mijn eerste experience van oor see, so ek sien nog wel uit.
En gestel jullie twee weer nou die miljoen rand, wat zou jij met jouw gedeelte doen, 500.000 rand?
Ik zal een deposit op een wilsplaas neerzet. Of dit zal definitief mij helpen om een deposit neer te zetten op een wilsplaas. Want het is iets waarvoor ik belangstel en wat ik graag zou willen doen een dag. Is het droom van mij om een nacht mijn eigen wilsplaas te hebben en niet te deel met wild en dat bedrijf ook een beetje te, je weet, te opbereid. Dat is een groot belangstelling van mij. Dus die goed wat ik lees en opzwat.
Fantastisch!
Ja.
Oh man, all the excitement. Dit is inderdaad fantastisch.
Lekker.
Remember to guess which celebs will be hotting it up on Tropical Island of Treasure Season 8. Of course, it's going down in the Maldives. Mm. And you could go straight through to the contestants' auditions. And we'll be posting a clue a day, so do keep checking the hashtag TIOT8. Today's celeb clue is exactly. Coming up right now.
Well, this fitness bunny keeps her training secrets in a vault. Follow her on Insta for meal prepping and set ripping. Mm. Who is she? Of course, you can answer this riddle on Tropica Island on Facebook or at MyTropica on Twitter and Instagram. And of course, get your guesses in.
Yeah, and remember to use the hashtag TIOT8. And as always, the terms and conditions can be found on clover.co.za. Who do you think it is, guys? Come on, get your guesses in.
Very, very exciting indeed. But on that note, jumping back into the kitchen, we are joined once again by Mike Cree, our Chief Creative Officer at 140 BBDO, talking about that awesome campaign that has just launched, H20, using chefs to inspire you to use less water. Right now, the awesome Pete Goffe-Wood back in the kitchen as well.
Brother.
Nice to see you. Nice to see you. So, Mike, before we get into our beautiful steak recipe, Pete, it smells amazing, by the way, so far. You told us a little bit about the H20 campaign, how that works, where it came from, but I mean, how would you like, specifically I think Cape Town, to get involved with this initiative? How can we do that?
Well, I think the key is just to hashtag waterless cooking. I mean, that's the big hashtag social media where you can start finding all the recipes from the different chefs. Chefs are going to start challenging each other. Got a whole lot of chefs on board. Just to give you some inspiring ways of saving water in a different way. And it's fun and it's imaginative. And it gets you thinking out of the box. So
okay.
I think
okay.
That's the key thing, hashtag waterless cooking.
Hashtag waterless cooking.
Smile FM have launched it this morning and they got 2 chefs on today. Okay. They're gonna cook in their studio.
There
so
you
it's
wow.
all happening, yeah.
Lekker, I love it, I love it. And you're obviously a Waterless Wednesday warrior, Pete.
Yes, indeed.
Taking a look, okay, let's quickly talk to me about your recipe, what you're gonna be making.
Okay, so we figured waterless, so braai is the obvious thing to think of. It's September, it's Heritage Month, Braai Day coming up. Heritage Day coming up. So we figured braai recipe, so you've got to have a bit of steak.
Dude, you can't go
you know,
wrong,
we can't go
steak,
wrong with a bit of steak. So here's a nice ribeye that I've had on the fire, lit and going. Simple recipe, a compound butter.
Okay.
There's lots of ingredients, but it's easy stuff. This is what I call a masala butter. So I'm going to bomb all this stuff into the machine. We've got some cooked onions and some garlic. We've got a little bit of curry powder. We have some anchovies, got to have anchovies. Capers. We have a little bit of ground ginger.
Nice.
Then lots of herbs. We've got some fresh coriander. and some basil.
Okay.
There we go. And just a little shot of Worcester sauce. And that's just gonna get whizzed up.
That's it. So you whiz that up. I mean, Mike, you also mentioned, you know, it's moving away from, we know that we need to save water when it comes to flushing our toilets maybe, or, you know, showering less or that kind of thing. But how much water do you, Peter, also from you, I think, yep. is kind of used within cooking, if you think about also massive restaurants?
Well, look, I mean, I think where also you have to be, to think about this, how you prep and how you do this. It's all very well saying we've now got a waterless dish. We still have to wash up.
That's the thing.
You know, yeah. So things like getting a small bucket in your sink, instead of filling your entire sink with soapy water, get a small container. It's a third of the water you'll use. You can wash everything that you'll use to cook today,
yeah.
And you haven't wasted an entire sink full of water.
Okay, yeah, because I think people don't realize how much water actually goes into the washing of the dishes, especially at a big establishment.
It's craziness.
Cool, so the keyword is steak. SMS out to 33728 for this delicious recipe. That's steak to 33728, and you could be making this on your Waterless Wednesday as well. So once again, just the quick blitz there.
So we just finished the butter off in there. Now, we've taken the liberty of making some butter earlier. Got a simple salad here of a little bit of grilled red onion, some rocket, a little bit of dressing. Now we have our beautiful ribeye that we've...
Oh, yeah, look at that, a tender. Wow.
And then we just have a nice healthy dollop of our masala butter and let that do its
thing. Yeah, tuna, steak, definitely getting spoiled for breakfast this morning, and didn't use any water to cook this, which is amazing.
No, and the fact that you'll be standing around the braai, so hydration is important. So obviously no water, but a nice ice cold glass of wine or a beer.
There we go.
Again, saving water all the time.
I love it. Pete, thank you very much. Thank you for joining this campaign. I think it's amazing. Thank you, Mike, for launching this campaign. Yeah. I think it's very cool. Check it out. So hashtag waterless cooking. That's where you can find it. It's going to be trending, hopefully, on social media as well. But the keyword is steak for our recipe this morning. SMS that to 33728. And then for both these delicious waterless cooking recipes we made this morning, check it out on our website, expressoshow.com.
Oh, that delicious meal makes me feel like it's weekend. But you know what? Every Friday on Afternoon Express, it's Winner Home Time, SA's premier interior design reality competition, proudly brought to you by Private Property. Now, if you vote for your favorite design duo, you stand a chance of winning the grand prize, a home at the Eye of the Africa Golf and Residential Estate with finishes by Plascon and Caesarstone and premier appliances by Grundig to the total value of 3 million rand. You are also automatically entered to win incredible prizes in the bi-weekly giveaway. The latest prize up for grabs is the Sealy Queen mattress and base set valued at 14,999 rand. So get your entries in now.
This is your chance to win the home you've always dreamed of. SA's favorite interior design reality competition, Winner Home, sees three design duos transform empty spaces into lavish homes. And one of them could be yours. To enter, visit privateproperty.co.za and vote for your favorite design duo. Put yourself in line to win amazing prizes in the bi-weekly draw and automatically be entered for a chance to win the grand prize, your choice of one of three fully designed homes in the Eye of Africa Golf and Residential Estate in the south of Joburg. The finished property will include luxurious finishes by Plascon and Caesarstone, as well as premier home appliances by Grundig, with a total prize value of more than 3 million rand. Competition details plus T's and C's can be found on the Private Property website. Watch the breathtaking properties come to life as the design drama unfolds and stand a chance to win the biggest prize on South African television, your very own dream home.
Ah, well, the fun, games and festivities continue. We've got our winner. We're going to reveal it in just a moment. But after the break, we're going to continue with our waterless cooking. We're going to whip up something completely genius. It's a smoked salmon cheesecake. Ah, we're going to blow the roof off with that one. And then, of course, Zoe continues to explore beautiful Istanbul. We'll see you in a moment.
I'm a dreamer. A doer.
I know the hustle.
I just need my money to hustle for me.
Let your money hustle for you. Get a bank account for 5 rand per month and bank on the NetBank app without using any data. See money differently. NetBank.
Welcome to it. This is your Feel Good Breakfast Show Expresso right here on SABC3. I almost can't believe it, but spring is here. And what a better way to introduce this new season into your kitchen than with a smoked salmon cheesecake, thanks to Clover Fresh Milk. Okay, now when I say smoked salmon cheesecake, you might have raised an eyebrow or two even, I don't know. But if you've never considered a savory cheesecake, you may have to get over this name, but you'll never get over your first taste. It's gonna be delicious. We have the lovely Lizet with us in the kitchen to show us the ropes. Hello, Lizet.
Hello.
Goed. Ek is blij. Listen, savory smoked salmon cheesecake.
Yes.
Wow. Because I'm when I hear cheesecake, it's you know, yeah. It's well, a cup of tea and it's yeah. Lekker.
Think of this almost as a quiche on steroids.
Okay.
You know, we're just adding some lovely cream cheese and some creme fraiche to make it richer and smoother and softer.
And I mean, I know salmon and cream cheese, it goes together. Already.
Marriage
you know.
Made in heaven.
Right, yeah. And let me guess, there's some chives in there as well.
Yes. You see? And dill.
And dill,
dill
okay.
Is very often
listen, let's make it using our clover milk here this morning. That's going to be an interesting one.
Right, so what we're going to do, it's just eggs. That is the base of any cheesecake or slash quiche.
Yes.
Okay. Then we're going to add a nice dollop, about half a cup.
Yeah, so good full
milk.
Cream milk.
Yes.
If you want, okay.
And then the cheese component comes in the form of some cream cheese.
Yeah.
And then to make it extra smooth and soft and unctuous.
Okay.
Some creme fraiche as well.
Aha.
This is basically a cultured cream.
There we go.
So I'm nicely dirty now.
That's all good. It's all good.
So you can maybe add the dill for us and the
okay,
and the chives.
So here we have some good old dill.
And some chives.
Right. Getting that. Let me help you clear up here for a second. All right.
And now, then,
so you've got to make it, you got to get it smooth there, Lizzie.
I know. But you're the one with the muscles, darling.
Okay, let me see if I can, you know, I might just make a mess. I don't know.
And
but
then
we'll
black
there.
Pepper.
There we go.
Masses of flavor in pepper.
Yeah.
And then a pinch of salt, but not too much, because smoked salmon is salty.
Yes.
And some brands are saltier than others.
Okay.
So taste your salmon first and then decide how much, and then rather undersalt and add at the table.
Yeah.
So perfect. That's brilliant.
Okay, how does that look?
You're the master of the whisk.
The master of the whisk. All right.
Okay, so that's great. And then what you can either make your own pastry, which is super quick if you look on the website, the recipe's there. You just bang a little bit of ingredients in your food processor and 2 minutes later you've
got
pastry. Or you can buy a pre-made pastry case and fill it.
I see.
So if you're going to make your own, just blind bake it, put it in, prick it, put some baking beans, blind bake it before you put your filling in. Otherwise you're going to have a soggy mess. And
we
no
don't
one wants
want
that.
To have soggy mess.
Okay. And now what we're going to do is this simply goes into our case.
All right. Beautiful. Now the keyword is Clover. SMS Clover to 33728 to get hands on this beautiful smoked salmon cheesecake this morning.
Going to drop in some smoked salmon. You don't have to use the fancy stuff for this because it's inside, it's not on top.
Yes.
Okay, so you can use the offcuts, which is they're considerably cheaper and they are packed with flavour, they're just not so pretty.
There
but you're
go.
Not gonna
But
notice.
I mean it's going into the quiche
it's going
anymore,
into
or the
cheesecake.
Cheesecake.
Yes. This Fantastic. Goes in an oven, low oven, like 160 until it's set.
Okay.
Well, it won't be set, but cook like 45 minutes.
Yeah.
Then leave it in there for another 45 but turn off the heat.
Oh, I see.
Okay,
so
and then it's going
slightly open.
No, just leave it closed, but just turn it off after 45 and then just leave it alone.
And it will look
like
that.
And it'll look like that when it comes out.
And then you have some fresh herbs to dress it with.
It's all about the pretty. So
it's all about the pretty. We love it. We're going to dress this guy. If you want to have your hands on the recipe, I think it's awesome. SMS the keyword Clover to 33728. But here are those steps one more time for you.
Thank you.
That keyword once again, Clover to 33728 for your smoked salmon cheesecake. And now, like Lizet said, it's all about the pretty. And it does look pretty. It really looks amazing and delicious at that as well. So is this a dinner, lunch, breakfast?
This is a fantastic lunch. Especially, yeah. You know, a girly lunch.
Yeah, a girly lunch, but hey, man.
In spring under a tree.
Manly lunch as well, come on. And spring, like this is definitely
this is such a spring dish.
Lizet, thank you very much. Definitely give this guy a try. Clover to 33728. Check it out on our website as well, expressoshow.com. Lizet, sit on da. Bam.
Clover fresh milk is way better. Made with love by Clover.
Now, as we celebrate Heritage Month this September, we as South Africans certainly can recognize the importance of history and its significance to the culture of a society. In fact, it reminds us of where society has been, how it's grown, how it's evolved, and also speaks to the innovations over the years.
Exactly. Well, certain cities in the world, like Istanbul, for instance, are full of ancient sites with incredible stories to tell, as Zoe discovered on her latest travel adventure.
In her exploration of Turkey, Zoe discovered the old capital, a side of Istanbul brimming with history and culture that harkens back to the Ottoman Empire and its rich heritage.
If there's one thing not to be missed in Istanbul, it is the Hagia Sophia. It's over 1,500 years old and it's been a place of worship for pagans, Christians and Muslims alike. Some consider it to be the eighth wonder of the world.
Couldn't understand why everyone made such a big fuss about it until I saw it with my own eyes. Walking inside, I was completely blown away.
In its long history, the Hagia Sophia has been a Christian cathedral and an Islamic mosque. The creation of a secular Turkish Republic in 1935, the Hagia Sophia became a museum.
Saraya, there's so much history wrapped up in these walls. What are some of the most impressive features of the Hagia Sophia?
On the main edge of the wall, we see the Virgin Mary with the Jesus Christ on his hands. We see a niche for the Muslims added during the Ottoman Empire period. And one of the most important things that we need to look at, one of the best calligraphic samples of the Islamic art.
Amidst the mix of religious artworks and structures, the mosaics in the upper gallery are awe-inspiring.
I love the mosaics with their intricate details, and despite the Hagia Sophia's constant renovations, these have survived for centuries. And what I like particularly about this one, it's an 11th century mosaic that has Christ in the middle, surrounded by Emperor Constantine and his wife, my namesake, Empress Zoe, and our name means life in Greek. The Hagia Sophia is such an iconic building, and to preserve it as best as possible, it's pretty much always under restoration, small sections of the museum. Regardless of the construction, it did not take away from that feeling you felt when you walked in and you looked up and you saw these beautiful ceilings.
Next to the Hagia Sophia in Istanbul's main square is the Sultan Ahmet Mosque, better known as the Blue Mosque. It was built in the 17th century and is recognizable by its domes and six minarets.
The Topkapı Palace was built about 550 years ago when the Ottomans defeated the Romans. We were granted special access to film behind the palace doors, but this is definitely a destination you need to add to your travel bucket list.
The palace was the political center of the Ottoman Empire between the 15th and 19th century and could house 5,000 residents.
The palace is divided into four courtyards, all serving a different purpose. To this day, the first courtyard is still open to the public. We're in the second courtyard where administrative business was handled. The third courtyard is the most important one, where matters of the state was discussed as well as decisions made. And my personal favorite, the fourth courtyard, is where the Sultan got to spend his private time with his family and friends.
Over 400 years, each sultan added a section or hall to the palace, and its architecture is predominantly Middle Eastern.
It really is a social environment, and I think that's something the Turks love to do, is they love to be social. This is such a breathtaking view, and one of the unique things about its location is that it's almost completely surrounded by the sea. It's got the Marmara, it's got the Bosphorus, as well as the Golden Horn. I feel like I'm channeling my inner princess.
Every princess needs a great place to rest. The five-star Ajwa Hotel is centrally located to Istanbul's great sights and offers comfort and luxury.
Arriving at the Ajwa Hotel, it looked how I pictured Istanbul to be. Walking into my room, there was the most beautiful bathroom. The tiles in the shower just took my breath away. The entire room was spacious, and they really, really paid attention to detail.
The ornate rooms boast handcrafted furnishings and beautiful views that make guests feel like royalty.
The breakfast spread for me was a great introduction to how the Turkish love their cuisine. I love the fact that there are so many options to choose from. I'm used to eating one set big breakfast. They have lots of little options, and I think for me, just having the choice to pick and choose what I wanted for breakfast was the winner.
A taste of the sumptuous history of Turkey can make you feel like you've traveled to a different era. So why not widen your world and come experience the beauty of Istanbul with Turkish Airlines?
Wow, that's amazing. Hey,
beautiful.
I wish I was
love
there.
It, love
well,
it.
Would you like to enjoy exploring Turkey as much as Zoe did?
Yes.
Well, Club, me too. Come on, put it there. Yes. Well, Club Travel is offering an 8-night package that will introduce you to some of Turkey's most special locations. And they're offering it to Expresso viewers for only 12,170 Rand. Now, for more information and to book your trip to Turkey, visit clubtravel.co.za.
Mm-hmm. And of course, there is more where you can stand a chance of winning a trip to Turkey, to Istanbul. And of course, all you then have to do is visit our Expresso Morning Show Facebook page and tell us why you would love to explore this place, this beautiful place, so much. It includes two flights and a 3-night stay in the beautiful city, and you'll get to check it out there. So go to our Expresso Morning Show Facebook page and tell us why you'd love to explore Turkey so much.
Turkish Airlines, widen your world.
So while the gaming fun continues on our 49-inch Beast QLED gaming monitor, Kat and I are going to give it a bit of a spin. Just now, we're going to continue with our cultural exploration, making some Moroccan chicken meatballs in the kitchen. And we're also going to connect with a brilliant Nigerian author. So more inspiration to come on the other side of this.
Welcome back. It's your Feel Good Breakfast Show. This is Expresso only on SABC3. Now, it's no secret. Everyone loves a good home-cooked meal made from scratch with fresh ingredients. But with our busy lifestyles, you know what? We don't always find the time to do that. Now, this morning, Waleed Amlay is here to tell us a little bit about the launch of an amazing new Knorr recipe mix that is packed with sustainably sourced natural ingredients and comes in an exciting range of 7 flavors, one for every night of the week. So you can literally whip up a nutritious meal for your family in just a few minutes. Waleed, welcome, brother.
How's it, man?
Nice to see you, man. Nice to see you and your box of freshness as well. I love
it. Yeah.
So listen, what inspired this brand new range of naturally tasty range?
So I think we're all looking for products that are more natural or contain more natural ingredients. And we still needed to offer us the flavor that we need. Right? So you've got to combine the natural ingredients with the flavor and then help us to easily prepare great tasting dishes at home.
Okay.
And this is exactly what the naturally tasty range brings.
I love it.
We love inspiring people like Knorr and offering choice. And this is exactly why we've launched the Naturally Tasty Range.
Absolutely. And what I love about this is using it, even if you're not a professional chef, I mean, your dishes can be
absolutely amazing. 80 wounds the rocker, so let's say. What's new about the range? What can people expect?
So it's a new range of recipe mixes or dry cooking sauces that are made entirely from natural ingredients. So ingredients that you can find in your kitchen at home that you use to cook from scratch with, that in your vegetable cupboards as well as in your herb and spices racks. You know, going into the supermarket, you pick vegetables out.
Okay, really so like you said, it's as natural as it can be.
Yeah, pretty much.
Right, so when you talk natural ingredients for the new Tasty range, I mean, exactly where do you kind of source these guys from? Where do you kind of put it together from the beginning?
So we strongly believe in sustainably sourcing our ingredients and supporting farmers who not only care for the environment, but care for their workers as well. And use sustainable sourcing farming practices to grow the ingredients. So we just believe that, you know, using them and supporting these guys to get our ingredients from, it's just better for everybody.
Exactly, it's better for everyone, better for the environment as well, which is amazing. Now, I know Knorr has been a household name for so many years. You know, families have been using it. I mean, I know, you know, back in the day, my mom has been cooking with it. But what you say makes it such a great addition to your cupboards. I mean, why should you have something like this? I mean, especially taking into account the busy days or busy lives that we live nowadays.
Sure. So, like I said before, I mean, you know, we look for ingredients that are more natural, but give us flavor, as well as helping us to prepare dishes easily. So this is kind of an all-in-one package. And the special thing about it, it's made from natural ingredients. So when I say natural ingredients, I mean the recipe mix is made from ingredients found in nature and that have minimal processing. Okay. We're talking about drying. That's basically it.
Okay.
Right? And you can see, if you read the back of pack, if you pick it up in store, it's very evident in the ingredient statement where the ingredients are easily recognizable. They're easy to read and understand. There aren't any funny names or preservatives or additives or colorants or any of those things.
Which is good to know, especially if you're going to be cooking for a family and 100%. You have a bit of a health aspect to it as well. And what I love about it is the fact that there's all these different flavors and you can, with our busy lives and schedules, you plan it out. You know exactly what's going to be happening day after day.
One for each night of the week.
One for each night of the week. Waleed, thank you very much for joining us, man. Love the range. Very, very cool. As a family man, I know that's definitely something that will make my wife's life a little bit easier.
Sure,
so thank you very, very much. So check it out. The brand new naturally tasty range from Knorr, making your cooking endeavors just a little bit easier and make sure that your dishes taste absolutely phenomenal. But we are going to be cooking with these with the naturally tasty range in just a little bit, so stick around for a delicious recipe in just a bit.
Cheers.
Knorr Naturally Tasty. Full of natural ingredients. Lekker.
Oh, yes. Listen, I've been looking for various ways of improving my cooking, and I'm liking this naturally tasty mixed recipe range. Eh?
That's right. That's why we have Charmaine Ramalope in the kitchen with us this morning.
So here in the Expresso kitchen, we are so excited about the new naturally tasty recipe mix range from Knorr. We couldn't resist having a little series to get into some of these exciting new cook-in sauces, and they look spectacular. So we are joined this morning by food blogger Charmaine Ramalope, also known as the Beyoncé of all things foodie. Charmaine is going to be kicking off the series with us with some incredible recipes. First up, a Moroccan recipe mix. And Knorr keeps it real with a product that is full of natural ingredients that are all sustainably sourced. We tick that box every time. Love it. So Charmaine, welcome to the show, first of all.
Thank you so much for having me.
It's an absolute pleasure. So my sources tell me we're going to take this incredible Knorr Moroccan tasty mix, which it looks delicious already, and we're going to turn it into a South African favorite. I'm seeing the pup. I'm seeing chicken ingredients. I'm guessing we're going to be making meatballs with a beautiful tomato sauce.
Graham, we're going to be making meatballs using the new Knorr Naturally Tasty Moroccan Chicken. It is full of flavor. You've got like smoky paprika, allspice, you know, like that beautiful exotic Moroccan spices, but we're going to transform it into a classic South African dish of meatballs and creamy bap with a tomato gravy.
Oh man, it sounds out of this world. So let's dive right in. Take us through the process.
Where do we begin? First, we've got our mince, chicken mince, and with that, we're gonna add our breadcrumbs.
Okay, just give it a bit of body.
Our coriander for flavor and give it a bit of freshness.
We have a standing joke here that I don't like coriander on the show. Maybe you will win me over.
Will transform you. A bit of sea salt and sprinkle of pepper.
I love it. And this is kind of a base for any meatball. You would kind of go this route, yeah?
Yeah, basically. And we put in a whole packet of the knorr. You can already smell. Like, natural flavors, all natural.
I see what you mean about that smokiness.
The smokiness is absolutely divine. So you mix that all up and you turn it into meatballs.
I love it. My mouth is already watering. And I know, look, we're adding the pup for a bit of substance, okay, but this is still really healthy. And the fact that we're using all natural ingredients that have gone into this cooking sauce mix.
All right, we've basically mixed all the different elements and we're going to create our meatballs. It's going to be very sticky, so brace yourself. And we put it in an oven-proof dish. We're going to bake it in an oven for about 10 minutes at 180 degrees Celsius.
Okay, I think using the chicken in this form, it does make it a lot quicker and
it
easier.
It is much quicker. It's like the ideal meal to make during the week when you're busy, you're from work, and you just don't have time. So
nice little protein kick. And you make it with your hands, and then I'm going to suggest you eat it with your hands. You've got the pup here as well.
Yeah, definitely.
And I have to say, the coriander, it does add a nice little pop of colour with our meatballs as well.
It adds that freshness because, as you know, with spices, it can be a bit heavy at times. So the coriander just gives it, like, that nice lift.
Cool. So I'm going to pop these guys into the oven, and we're going to do one of our magical TV dissolves, and we're going to move on to our almost finished product. Pop you guys in here for 10 minutes. There's a little lappy for you. So now we move on to our meatballs, which of course we have kind of par cooked already. But what goes into our tomato sauce here?
What goes into our tomato sauce is a tin of tomatoes, some tomato paste, the knorr vegetable stock pot, and some sugar, and of course water. And you basically mix that all together. And then you put your meatballs, which should be in the oven for about 10 minutes, and then you put them in the sauce to cook for another like 5 minutes just to get the flavors, you know, all rounded
all
up
of that
nicely.
Infuse. I love that. Yeah. So now we get to do the best part of this entire process and put it all together. And I'm glad we've gone with a bowl here that I can really fill up. I don't know if you want to bring across our beautiful chicken meatballs a la Moroccan style. And the key word here, you guessed it, is knorr, to 33728. We'll send you this rather simple ingredients list via a link. You just click on the link and the rest is yours.
Yes, the knorr Naturally Tasty is available. If you want to try it out, that's where you should.
Oh, man. Steaming and full of goodness, and we're still getting those beautiful smoky flavors.
Smoky flavors, it's absolutely.
I'm telling you, the best way to do this is delicious. With your hands.
Yeah.
Oh, Charmaine, you have outdone yourself, and hopefully this is just a jumping off point for you, and it'll inspire you to use your Moroccan mix in 100 different ways. The idea here is to use these really good base ingredients and just have a little bit of fun. Now let's see if you can win me over. Oh, it looks absolutely amazing, guys. You need a close-up of that. Just take a look.
Well, African literature that tells authentic African stories with real African people are such a value in these contemporary times. Now, that's why it's so worthy to celebrate new literary voices, and helping us to do just that today is Nigerian author Ayobami Adebayo, here to chat about her spectacular debut novel called Stay With Me. And of course, we want to give her a very warm Expresso welcome. So good to have you on the show this
morning.
Thank
you for having me.
So just to contextualize, your book is about a Nigerian husband and wife. It follows them through the decades and, of course, showcases their, or rather tells the story of them trying to conceive a child and, of course, the traditional things that come in there. The question that I want to ask first and foremost is, how do you believe that political happenings can really shape one's life?
I don't think it's possible to separate the political from the personal.
Yeah.
And the story of this novel is a couple who's trying very much to stay away from what's happening politically, but that becomes impossible towards the end of the book because there's a clash between that. So I don't think it's possible to separate the two.
Yeah. Mm. You've also got some very strong female voices coming out here, which is so wonderful because I think a lot of the times the political systems, cultural systems, religious systems seem to like stifle our voices. Mm. But tell us more about how you bring that out in this book.
Now with the lead character, who's Yejide, a Nigerian woman, who is not supposed to have a voice in her marriage until she has a child. Mm. And it was very important to me to have a point of view in the novel that we get to hear from her directly. Because more often than not, a woman's legitimacy sometimes is decided by how many children does she have? Does she have male children? And how many male children does she have? So it was important for me to have a woman who for a significant portion of the novel didn't have any children, and she did have important things to say about herself and about society.
I love how these strong messages about women and about who we are and, of course, our place in the world is becoming more and more prevalent in today's world. Mm. But you were also coached by some really acclaimed international authors. Can you tell us who they were and also how they helped to shape your narrative in this book, Stay With Me?
Yes. So about 10 years ago, I was much younger then. I attended a workshop with Chimamanda Ngozi Adichie in Lagos. And it was really spectacular because she taught the importance of rewriting, that if you want to really write, it's important that you go over what you've done again and again.
Wow.
And then I studied in England with Margaret Hatwood at the University of East Anglia. And she was just absolutely marvelous. And one of the important things I took away from her was that if you want to write, you have to read. Mm. I sort of already knew that, but she re-emphasized it to the point where even though I really loved to read before, I came to recognize that it was a discipline that I needed to practice.
Yeah. Well, definitely, you've practiced it, and it is absolutely incredible. And you're doing such wonderful work, and I think it's such a special time for us as women. We've got a long way to go, but we've certainly come a long way as well, and your voice is adding to that progression and transformation. So thank you so much, Ayobami, for being here.
Thank you so much. Yeah.
And of course, if you want to get a taste of what Ayobami has written, go and check out her novel, Stay With Me. It's available at all major bookstores. Well, of course, we are going to take a quick break. A little bit more to come on your Feel Good Breakfast Show. Don't move a muscle. We'll be right back.
Turkish Airlines voted Europe's best airline for 6 consecutive years. Widen your world with outstanding hospitality as you journey in style to your destination. Enjoy a stopover in Istanbul and discover the colors of this fascinating city. With Turkish Airlines, your stopover will include complimentary accommodation in Istanbul, and you can experience the wonder of 2 continents combined in an unforgettable adventure. To learn more about the best stopover in travel, visit turkishairlines.com.
You beauty!
Why does this guy not
get in there, man?
Oh, they gave you the wrong IC, that's the terminal. I know, I can see.
Whoa, you bluxum!
what's reverse? What's reverse?
It's A or I think it's
yes,
A.
Yes, what it?
Wow.
The freak was that?
It was an accident. It was an accident.
Okay, so do we get to choose our own cars, guys? Or what's the deal?
Hello?
Do we get to choose our own cars?
Just play the cards you have.
How is this oak? Just play the car that you have.
It's just for fun.
No, it's never just for fun, Lucian. It's never just for fun. What are you talking about?
It's just for fun. It's just for fun.
No, yes, like this thing doesn't turn. What the hell? I don't want to play this car.
Why? It's just for fun. It's never just for fun, Lucian.
It's my feel-good breakfast show.
Welcome back. This is your Feel Good Breakfast show, and we've had an exciting one, especially with all of our gamers. And since it's Gaming Wednesday and with Vodacom Make Your Day, you can get free data to play your favorite games online.
That's right. Simply keep a positive data balance on your Vodacom SIM card, then dial *111*634#, or you can download the latest version of the My Vodacom app and remember to opt in daily so you don't miss out on the 1 gig free data every day. And for more information and T's and C's, visit vodacom.co.za.
Oh, I don't think the car's supposed to do that. It's beautiful. Forza 6 has been our battleground today. Thank you so much to all of our gamers who have kind of put your reputations on the line this morning, but there can only be one. I have to ask, first of all, brilliant experience, I know that, but ultimately there is one champion. Dude, grab that box next to you. Rael is our reigning champion. Oh, 27 inches of glory right there, guys. Thank you so much. And of course, we've been playing on our 49-inch QLED. It is an absolute game changer. You guys at home can win yourself a 24-inch QLED gaming monitor. Go to our Facebook page. Let us know what you like most about this. There are a host of features. You guys, give yourselves a pat on the back. There are no losers on the show. Well, they are, but I mean, you know. Thank you so much to everyone who's joined us this morning. Thank you so much to Samsung for being so generous. And we love you. We get to do this all over again tomorrow. Who's winning? Come on, boys.
Don't talk to me.
Come on, focus.
Don't talk
focus.
To me.
Well done, guys.
Expresso Morning Show, made with love by Clover.
Another feel-good production.